staring at on the computer screen?
I was actually looking.
Is the question?
I was looking for the article that you started to read regarding why are women attracted or whatever, what women are attracted to men, blah blah blah.
Okay.
And as a result, that it's pretty much a science, boy. You're just not supposed to finish reading it. I think so. It does.
That's all you were looking at on the computer screen for your eyes to be hurting you.
Yes.
And your eyes get blur.
It was a student computer. It wasn't mine.
And the difference?
If it was mine, I probably would have been looking at other things.
Point taken.
Yes.
Point taken, bossy. Point taken. All right.
And I would have, and in that case, I would have put on my glasses to ensure that I'm
seeing
properly.
Ladies, you hear all my co-host rude though. Daddy rude, man. Daddy rude. Well, how was your week?
I had a lovely weekend. I had an assignment to do for my daughter. I was supposed to make a human skeleton out of...
Oh, Lord.
What's something
named? Play-Doh?
Cartridge paper.
Cartridge who?
Cartridge paper. You want to see?
I would love to see it.
Okay, I'm going to let you see it.
I trust Momo wasn't disappointed.
And me not so sure. But no, she was pretty good. All she come and do and look at it and then she laugh and go like she ridicule me. But I work with it still. You know, I'm not complain. Let me see if I can bring it up right here. Pity people can't see it. But it is what it is.
Okay, you go on so.
So you can swipe that way to see.
Then, oh, you meant this. Oh, my goodness. But yeah, you study road.
Oh, yeah, I mean.
You are an architect? You have architectural experience or abilities?
Yeah.
Anyways,
I no longer do that.
Oh, but you can. Yeah, what it takes to do something like this for your baby girl.
Yes.
Put it that way.
Yes, but
I
don't.
So why are foot them so open up? Skeleton foot.
Go on again, my lord. Why have you stopped this?
Oh, I was just wondering. People, I was just saying the skeleton, like, you know, like she doing broke it down or something. Made a wonder. Or make it warm back from my back. Like she was dancing. But it's nice.
Thank you.
Is it on cottage paper?
Yep.
Oh my goodness. But you have used that the road.
Ish.
You don't know but I'm what this so. No, that doesn't sound good, though. Yakisha in Texas. Big up, yes. I can't call a word here.
Scorpio.
Big up yourself, Miss Scorpio Linky. Scoop, 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 scoop. Yeah. Yes, Miss Spooky Prestige. All right, by November. I told you he was a November man. Yeah.
Good
and
night.
That movie, by the way, is off the
Where
chain.
The last
November
part?
Man. Oh, Daddy Road, good night. Good night, Daddy Road.
Okay. Good night, Yakisha.
Yeah. All right.
No, so. I used to do home designs.
Oh, yes. Cool. I love that.
Interior decor? Nope, just strictly
design.
Designs,
okay.
Drawings,
I love
working drawings.
I love interior.
And probably 6 years now, I stopped.
Packed it up.
Just like that.
Oh, just like that.
Yeah.
All right.
Persons who are interested overseas, etc., in doing that, my younger brother does it.
Okay.
And he's very good.
Okay. I have no doubt about that. And I can tell you, for those who might want to know, I have some skills. These hands are very gifted, can I tell you?
I think the viewers have seen you doing your hand motions. And I'm
not talking about those skills right now. Those are a different set of skills. Yeah?
Those are assets.
Right? But I love the concept and the idea of decorating a home
or an office space. I love that. I sew
very well. I mean, my machine is down now, but I'm going to get another one.
Mm-hmm. I can't do color. I'm
good with those.
Take away a good time for figure out the colors.
So those who might be interested in anything like that, you know where to hook up Lady Cleo. Yeah. You have a baby's room you want to design or an office space, and I'll do minor paintings as well, not the large scale ones, but I'll do some painting and, you know, coordinate your colors for you and so on and so forth. If you need a fashion consultant, I'm right here. Yeah. I'm multifaceted.
You kind of too much, I know. You know. Come, make it 9:30. Make it 9:30. Because I have a question to ask her after 9:30.
Okay, fine. Well, here's our friend from Connecticut. I love Connecticut, by the way. Big up yourself, Connecticut peeps. Yeah? Hello, Real Talk, for some reason. I'm getting the same show whenever I try to listen in to the playback program. All right, Laurie. Well, we can just sort that out for you and tell you what's happening. Reinstall the app, honey.
Yeah, because I've heard persons say that, but so, it doesn't happen to my phone. I don't know.
Okay. Try reinstalling. All right, Laurie.
And if it doesn't work, let me know, please.
All righty. Thanks for hooking up.
Send me a WhatsApp, 876-439-5160. That right, Cass? Yeah.
Repeat that for her.
876-439-5160. And let me know.
All
if
right.
If it still continues.
All righty.
All right, it's now 9:30. And a half, ladies and germs. We're going to a break, and do remember the time is brought to you by VGA Printing Services. Real Talk is sponsored by Bayview Eco Resort and Spa, and also Builders Depot.
Depot, we soon come back.
This is Styles FM.
Architects, draftsmen, and surveyors, get your drawings printed in high-quality professional standards. We can satisfy your printing needs. Whether it is for presentation to your clients or for submitting building and subdivision application, make it VGA Printing Services. Whether drawing by hand or with computer-aided softwares, we will plot your negatives and print the copies as you need. We do high-quality white paper printing that is water-resistant and never fades, unlike traditional blueprint. For more information, call VJ Printing at 893-2266.
Do you have or are you seeking a place to rent, seeking employment or have a job vacancy? Are you selling a car or having a garage sale? Then come see us. Let Styles do the advertising for you and you'll be on your way in no time. Contact us at 876-286-9216 or 439-5160. Advertising Style. Advertise with Styles.
Are you planning on doing construction or building repairs soon, or just simply in need of household items? Builders Depot, located at Bryan's Bay, Port Antonio, Jamaica, stocks building materials, electrical and plumbing supplies, paints, tools, plus household items to make your dream home a reality. And guess what? We have a special payment arrangement for overseas customers. Contact us at 876-715-3128 or 876-284-3337. Builders Depot. Once you need it, we have it. Builders Depot, a sponsor of Real Talk with Lady Cleo and Daddy Rude, Monday nights from 9 p.m. to 12 midnight.
This feeling is taking over me. I'm so excited.
What? Feel the euphoria.
Tuesdays from 5 to 9 p.m. with the master mixer musical maestro Digital T.
Giving a total satisfaction with melodies and memories by the score. With the widest selection of genres and hits. So you don't know the program, you turn up, you know. So you know Patek's a full dance, the one you slap with. Hey,
digital and we are party, yeah we flawless. Hey. Euphoria the program, every Tuesday. Hey.
5 to 9, every Tuesday.
With the musical maestro Digital T.
Bayview Eco Resort and Spa. Boasting amenities such as restaurant, bar, spa, conference area, and swimming pool, we're perfect for a business trip or vacation. Make a reservation today by calling us at 993-3118 or email us at bayviewecoresortspa@gmail.com.
Welcome back. Yeah. Welcome back, guys.
I have a question to ask you because last week we were discussing the whole with the vox pop, the whole thing about bully, and I can tell you, say, between Tuesday and Wednesday, a number of persons were still calling me or sending me WhatsApp messages that they had listened to the show, and they were remembering. And it is so ironic. Those who called, save and except Shelly. I have to rate up Shelly, you know. Big up Shelly.
Big up all the time, Shelly.
Because Shelly are the only one who admittedly, well, no, she didn't admittedly, but she confessed indirectly that she was a bully in school.
Really?
She actually gassed people, pitting and all, and sitting there. Right? Now, between Tuesday and Wednesday of last week, a number of persons actually called me or sent me WhatsApp messages that they were bullies in school.
They were bullies?
They were bully.
Wow.
Right. One person in particular reminded me, well, told me that she remember, she was like a part of a crew. So she said it was more an influence. Mm-hmm. So she had influential kids, you know, peer pressure, etc. Yeah. Which I really believe still.
Mm-hmm.
No, I'm gonna believe in a fair case.
Okay, in her case.
No,
okay.
Right. So like she would have, they would have like one closet in the classroom.
Mm-hmm.
And when teaching are there, then we all get kids, two kids, and lock them up in the
ouch
closet. And then bet, so they must have a fight and then bet walk a win.
Oh my goodness. Them kids had great imagination.
I think they're just hustlers, right?
Oh my goodness.
Some young Don Kings. But my question to you, mm-hmm, I'm looking back at the Vox Pop, and I'm going to read it. It reads, what would you tell your child to do if you found out that he or she is being bullied at school? And who would you approach about the problem? The bully, the parent of the bully, or the teacher? And as a teacher, I'm sure you have experience in kids being bullied.
Oh yes, definitely.
How is that dealt with? How you treat it? And how does parents come to you?
Well, I've heard, yes, I've had instances, not since year or immediate last previous year, but I've had parents complain that children are picking on their children. For me though, I use a time factor to determine or to help me to determine or ascertain if this child is really being bullied.
In the sense, time factor.
In the sense that, okay, let us say a child and another child had an incident.
Yeah.
You can have bullying which occurs one off, yeah?
Yeah.
But for me to call in a parent on an issue, if it's a minor issue, I try to deal with the kids. If it's a little bit bigger than that, GC, then you go to principal. But there are some instances where you wouldn't necessarily say call in a parent readily, because it's a case that could be dealt with in school and you don't have to call a parent.
No,
now, let us say one child punched the other one because took up a pencil and break the pencil and she licked the child or whatever. Something like that you're not going to call in a parent for. You're the teacher, so you try to deal with it in an amicable way. No, I wouldn't call that bullying.
That's not a bully.
Exactly. So I'm saying there are some issues, even if another one might be jeering and teasing one, you say, yeah, them big, whatever. They might consider that bullying or whatever, right? So I'm saying, like that, for example, I wouldn't call a parent in because another child and another one say, I big, our ear, whatever. I wouldn't readily just call a parent. It has to be an as real serious issue.
Yeah, like what?
Come
in a face, tell your son, in a face, you call nobody, no pity parents, you know?
No, man, I call in parents, man, but it depends on the situation. Why are we there?
Who you call? You call the parent with the bully pity or the one that is being bullied?
It depends on the situation. I'd call in both. And usually, I don't even have to call in the one that is being bullied, because the one that is being bullied, that parent would normally come to say, teacher, X and Y and Z.
So hold on. You're never in a situation where two parents outfit knackfist.
No, thank God. No.
So kind of boring school.
I feel like bullying you right now. I swear for saying that. No, oh my goodness. No. I am glad I've seen where one part
straight
of
up.
No, seriously.
Me not think nobody will listen to Real Talk tonight. No, believe you. Nobody.
Don't try to beat at the people then, please.
No, but
in my 18 years of being in the classroom.
We can't say, pick somewhere. You try to be right.
Can I speak? Because this is Real Talk. And I ain't afraid to speak. I just choose not to or choose to. No, I have had one parent on one side,
yeah,
furious, fuming, and angry.
So the parent never rush you yet?
No.
No, sir.
Never have a parent rush me, no. I guess they'll talk behind your back, but you don't know. And if you might hear say,
all
one
right,
parent
suppose,
did
all right
say.
Me know, so me
but I can't.
Me did have like a mischievous
one parent, but the parent. Yeah, hold on. Talk,
no, yes, no, no, yes. Talk
but the issue wasn't with me personally.
Mm.
It was an issue where the child wasn't one of my immediate students either, and another school children had an issue. I was trying to deal with the issue.
Like you polish it up because a while ago, you know,
no, because knit up. I remember the man.
Bro, them knit up.
I just remember the fact that the man actually got so upset that he grabbed the other school children, and we were saying, no, you can't do that. We're trying to get the children away from him.
In grab up other people's fitness?
Yes.
So what you wanna do? You wanna call for them parent?
We don't know them. We don't know them any at all. We try to get the children away from him or him away from the children.
So you wanna beat him?
Beat him? I more like him, they wanna beat we.
So what was
and it's just ironic at the end of the day. He must be embarrassed, must have been embarrassed because the way he was behaving as if his child was the one who was wronged. And she did nothing wrong, or she's always well behaved. That played out to be not the truth in the long run, both at that school and wherever else the child went afterwards.
Pitney, a bad pitney.
Yes, in a sense. Or even if you don't put
let
it
me ask a question.
Boldly bad.
Hold on. Let
the
me
child
ask,
has
me
clearly has some
you.
Behavioral problems.
I have a question to ask you. And this is a real talk. I'm a brethren, Drake. This is a real talk in a real life. Seeing? Over the weekend.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus Christ.
Mm-hmm. What happened now over the weekend?
All right. A friend of mine, family friend, me and current friend, seeing? Son attend a certain school. And there's this particular friend, I think 8-year-old,
mm-hmm.
That's at the age group. Where the next boy apparently me read it up and say boy the boy must have little issues because the boy in a class and every report we make about him have something to do with sex.
Mm-hmm.
Now this is the part that disturbed me with the little boy. When me understand the little boy they at school I tell him them say boy him do you know what to girls and him do you know what to boys. So I'm boy picking, you know.
Ouch.
Now the mama said boy she never knew about that. She didn't know when could I get that from. Apparently I don't even know what he asked her because that's what I bought up a little boy and I tell the truth. I bought up a little boy. God no. I mean I wonder if me shouldn't well.
Mm.
If your ear say you're a picnic in one classroom and one little boy did it, no matter where you get it from and talk about him do you know what to girls and him do you know what to boys, you know, if you burn him up, brr.
Mm.
And when all the woman who are going to know where you get it from, you burn up shit, man, brr. Me wrong, teach?
Mm-mm.
Talk to me, teach. Tell me. Talk to me, teach. Because when me think back about it, when me I drive from distance, I mean I say, John, you know, so I'm ashamed of myself because I fast and people argument and I take the phone from mom and I say, mom, put the phone on speaker. I mean I talk to my friend and I say, yo, right now, you can't make a youth part with a boy because you can't trust him. Because they make excuse. You know, he might have said, but he don't know what he must say. I say, look here, when me did in a grade 3, me about that age, I mean I use my pencil. Me not telling me
oh,
I use a
please
pencil.
Don't. Please don't. Kadian says, happy birthday, belated. Oh, thank you, Kadian, darling.
Oh, my goodness.
Charm says, she's not like the time change because we're on the same time with her. No, yeah, she's not like the time change at all.
Oh,
yes, it was
early,
more convenient,
you know,
for her when it was Osh a little, Charm. Yeah, on our head. Osh, darling. Why? And Kevin from Florida. I'm imagining right now. Thank you, Kevin, my dear. Thank you so much.
It's sad feeling shaming myself.
Oh, boy. Gracie. Good night, Gracie. We see you. Hey, Drake. How you doing? Where's Mrs. Drake?
I'm going to find a
picture. Taria, big up yourself as well. I'm not even listening to you, you know, because I'm start imagine what you do with a pencil. Mrs. Drake and Mr. Drake, big up. Enough love, all right? All right.
Oh,
so
we'll find a fit in the apologize. So Miss Africa should then still what?
Oh Jesus. Oh boy.
Janua Star.
The voices.
Forgive me.
At the time the bingo coming a play, Pebbles done. Okay then.
It's a bun up drink. Straight bun up, because me just honestly,
let's open Drake and see what Drake has.
No, bun up, brr. Brr. Bun up.
Open the WhatsApp that Drake sent.
Yeah, man.
What's the matter with it tonight?
No, but me glad to Cassidy, I'll pass and never follow you neither.
First, she said about man go feel no, she have gifted hands, then multi talented. Then that lady need to do like me. I have 2 radio app on my phone, 1 for Styles and an international radio, so Styles can't pass me. No time in a real life, laugh out loud. All right, Drake, good to know. Good to know.
Well, and when me hear the 2 women them as being prim and proper parents, and maybe him not know him really, I said, because you know sometimes everything kids hear them pick up and all them crap. So I start thinking of myself when me at 8. And me know say mommy and daddy never send me gas call.
Let's open the voice WhatsApp.
To be rude, you know what?
The voice WhatsApp, please.
You know what? Hear me the people. So me can't tell you no.
he says he loves interior as well. Yeah, up my alley, yeah. At them time, the bingy coming and play at Pebbles done. Bingy slingshot.
Go to Javin. You
okay,
see?
Okay, then.
Him say he loves interior as well, and you said up your what?
Whatever. Let's move along with the show. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Thank you very much, Daddy Road, for highlighting.
Is what you said. So, straight up.
I'm right, talking about decor up my alley. That doesn't sound very good at
no,
all.
No, that's why I'm left it alone.
Decor up my alley. Okay, let's move along with the show. Yes. Let's
so, you're not interested in our
business? Not at all.
You have no interest whatsoever in what I did.
Mm-mm. I can't contain myself tonight. What did you do, Daddy Road? The pencil now?
Left it alone.
Don't tell me you were a young Trump.
No, I didn't grab anything.
Okay.
I didn't grab anything.
Oh, okay, good to know.
But I use it to look.
The pencil?
Yes.
You were a young Trump. You were a young Donald Duck.
Oh, Lord.
Hey, Nova Peru. Nova in Peru. Good night to you too, my darling. And she says, Peru, Illinois, locked in. And okay, she wishes me happy belated. Thank you, sweetie.
At age 8, I knew not what I have done.
Uh-huh. Oh, that was Harry Potter when you were age 8. Yes.
Anyway, all right. Ladies and gentlemen, you know, that was just... Anyway.
But thank God I haven't had any experiences like those.
Yeah.
Yes.
But the bully thing a real thing, you know? But
yeah, real thing.
I think me like
and can I tell you Donald Trump is a bully? For those who don't know, he is a bully.
Tomorrow are the
elections, yeah. All you people out there, go on out and vote, and please vote for me. That is to help to make Hillary Clinton win. I can't vote, so y'all vote. All right? Yeah, please. Please don't put that monster, that bully, in the White House. Have a call online. Hello. Hello, caller. We lost the caller. All right. We invite you to call back if you so desire. All right. So people go out there and vote. Vote, 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 vote. All right. So Cleo, you keep a birthday party, so private, happy belated. No, man. I said it week before last, before I left, that November 6th would have been my birthday. And I remember Kevin was asking what I wanted. Yes, if my memory serves me correctly. So I said it, you know, I just wasn't here last week. Unfortunately, circumstances beyond my control, I couldn't come in last week. So can you not hear me say chat about my birthday? Because I just love birthdays. I don't care what anybody say, I just love birthdays. I love birthdays, but I just hate what comes with it. No, the age.
Where do you feel birthday?
Oh, nothing much. Really, I rested.
No,
I got dinner.
You know, would you talk about it for true?
Yes, I did. You did not remember.
We talk about it, you know.
I'm hating you right now.
No, when I made up mention
I'm
the age
you
thing
right now.
I'm gonna ask you how close it is to certain.
Oh Jesus!
Number.
Don't go there. I even pushed myself a year ahead. Can you imagine? That's sick. Anyways, call online. Hey, caller, good night.
Hi, Sister Cleo. How are you?
Hi, sweetie. How are you? I'm fine.
I'm good. I'm just calling to say a happy belated birthday to you, my dear.
Thank you, honey. Thank you, darling.
I love your vibes every Monday night.
So, what happened to me? She said, Cleo, give me a break now. Stop stealing my show. Thank you, honey.
My name is Dania. Always listen to you.
All right, Dania. Where are you calling from?
From Castle.
All right. I hope to meet you soon.
No problem.
All right, darling. Keep it locked, all right?
Okay, then.
All right. Have a great one. I just love the listeners, let me see. And I met two last week, two gentlemen. One lady said to me, this man listens to you every time. And he don't know you, let me introduce you. And he was like, oh, I don't remember his name, though. I'm not good with names readily. Can I tell you? And he said, oh, you're Lady Cleo. Yeah, man, the voice match the look. I hope it's a pretty look. I don't know. But nice meeting you. We met right at Lime. The flow office right there. So, yes, nice meeting you. And another gentleman who operates a taxi. I don't remember his name either. I met him and he introduced himself to me. And it was a pleasure meeting you. And another one in the liquor store on William Street. Big up yourself, my youth. Yeah. Marvin. I think it's Marvin him name. Yes. And I met somebody else somewhere too, but I can't remember where. But all the peeps who I met in the last week or two, yeah. Big up on yourself. Wanna keep it locked to styles. We love it. All right. Caller on 453. Hey caller, good night.
Good night. This is Anthony.
Hi, Anthony. How are you?
I'm good. I just listen to your program. I just want to jump into topic in your program. You know, so when I used to go to school in Kingston,
mm-hmm.
I had this school named Shekola Park.
Yes.
In Kingston. And I used to play marble. And, you know, seriously, when you used to play the marble for your child, I always win marble, okay, good for marble.
Mm-hmm.
So, you have a set up guy who live on a town.
Yes.
Kingston. And we live at Orange Street. And every time I bring them, you know what I'm doing to me?
Mm-hmm.
Young me, I think about the marble, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, 4 days I can't go to school, you know. then say they're going to beat me up, you know.
Oh, my.
I jump over a blood bank. You used to jump over a blood bank and go over the school, like a Shekola Park.
Oh.
So me I tell her, when we said me have to do them one day, mm-hmm. I'm a bigger uncle.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Got this school and started different me. And so me kinda brave enough, you know. But some uncle gone, they take by the
blood bank.
The blood bank again.
Yes.
And the boy them them got take my lunch money and take her back my marble them everything.
Oh, my.
So much days when I started high from school, so I go one day, my mother said, where your homework there? Pian show no homework, come on out. Every time if you go to school, they cast some bigger boys them. And you know when them boys are bigger than you, know,
mm-hmm.
you know. But they are licking their head and all
this.
And kick past their foot, they are going in and something there now.
That's Buddhism.
So, yeah, but I was blood back, I say I walk.
Mm-hmm.
One day, you know, me and my mother come on with me, you know, at school and say she can't hold me now, get the ocean out, no homework.
Yes.
But that's what's up now. Then me and them days, the teacher was the beat, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So you have a principal always use one something called the fan belt.
Ah,
oh,
Jesus.
So I never tell him, say, boy, here, you know. Them guys, every time I play marble with them, mm-hmm. they beat me up and take my lunch money. I saw me go back at school, you know.
Yes.
I end up my left hand, left that school, and go that school in Comprey, that is near college, senior school.
Yes.
And that school now.
That's in Portland.
No, man, it's in Kingston.
Oh.
Back a fire station in Prince up top, Princess Street.
Okay.
Yeah, so, man. And them guy, you know, I saw now them guy, you know, growing together, you know. Then start see me now and start to defend me now. I know them like never defend me.
Yes.
They beat me up and now they start defend me now, you know. So as me too start them get them like a school.
Yes.
Me more like a love to spar with the girls them.
Oh, okay. You're a smooth one. You weren't coarse.
Yeah. Yes. The boy, they must beat me, man. They must beat me, man. Oh, beat me bad. I have to take blood bank every minute.
But right? Every time you beat them, you still go back and play, man, with them, man.
No, me, you are going to play with different guys.
Oh.
You say you play marble, but you're a boy, you're mark. This marble game is a gambling, but it's a sport.
Oh, okay, sir.
Yeah, so I mean, so I know. When you hear say you give me a win marble, then we're permanent school over, you know.
Okay.
But not to say my way from the job, blood bank and gone.
Oh.
Because I said, boy, we are over here. Because you're not supposed to be over blood bank.
Yes.
And then they just throw the needle them all over the place. So then you're not supposed to be over there.
Well, guess what? The blood bank has been a refuge for you all these years. I trust one of these days you will go there and give some blood here. Voluntarily. Donate.
Yeah.
All right, caller. Thank you so much for sharing.
Thank you.
All right.
Well, unfortunate because our girl used to beat me up and take my rubber band them.
Which one worse? The man them beat you up or the boy or the girl?
The most of the girl I beat.
That one definitely worse.
I used to go to my granny yard a summer holiday time. My grandfather used to work a bank, so he used to carry him like an elastic band. You know, and... Why? Me take my elastic band and jump over the wall next door.
Blood bank too?
No, man.
Who's checking?
On Summer's Town Road.
Okay.
I remember, me tell you.
A girl?
Yeah, man, a girl.
She was a tomboy?
I mean, even knowing a star, y'all is bad here, sir.
But not you, clearly.
Big on me and bad on me.
Oh, boy. People, you heard it from Daddy Rude. A girl beat him up when he was younger and took away his elastic band. So now you hear him on radio, just mount him up, you know. Because right now I'll clear and dust him out. Yeah?
Mm.
And I'm not bigger necessarily. Well, I'm bigger. Getting bigger. All right, guys. Taria says, let's hope us. I want him better to open Taria. I'll just open the WhatsApp messages from Taria because I can't manage this. Co-host the man. All right, before we go to the text line, let's see what this next caller has in store for us. Hello, caller. Good night.
Good night.
Hi, how are you?
Cleo.
Are you a consultant decent?
Cleo, you didn't listen last week.
I wasn't able to, sweetie.
Cleo.
Yes? No. Why would I do that, honey? You sound... No. Hold on. Me like the bad girl song when you come out with a night time. A while ago, you were the polished Shelly. So when I said decent, I mean your decent side came out readily.
Why?
Because I mean, listen, if you call on a cuss out that dude right now about something, I mean, I hear that. So I'm like, hello, caller. You know, hear me up on hello, caller, good night. Okay, honey, continuing that same light then. Go ahead, honey.
So, were you listening last week?
I wasn't able to, sweetie.
After me, defend myself, you know. Daddy would just tell me all time on worldwide radio, you know?
Yes.
Then me admit to me a bully.
Yes.
So you know what I'm going to next time you see me.
Oh, whoa.
Bully him, I'm not care.
You're going to bully him in, out, and around.
I'm slap the way I get in and shine head.
Yes. I'm sorry for you.
I have to defend myself, me and my cousin. Defend myself, you know, after the boy them promised to do it. I come, if the police can look for me now.
Mm-hmm.
I said, I say, a bunch of girls, you know, the girl go on 99 to school and go like them better than you.
Hear the partner. Talking.
The girl come at school with our money, and you know, they can't go like them sweet because them bag might look better than your own and them have the money and them pocket. So she go like sweet. We used to styling. So she go like she want to style me. So I tell her, I say, we used to school over.
Then how bully that clear? Talk it short.
No.
Hypocrite talking short. Hypocrite talking short. Cassidy, don't bully that. Simple as that. See it?
I see you trouble me first.
Don't trouble when I trouble you.
Listen, because no matter how you want to put it, you had it bully.
No, me had him on the bully. The boy always a text it for me, Cleo, me beat him up. Me never know if I like him like me, but he always a text it for me.
But, my girl, you know, say you throw gas and all kind of nasty sitting on the boy then.
But Daddy Road, we couldn't make a boy then beat with a two girl.
Not innocent girls though.
Why, Shelly? Shelly, you're going some damage at school though.
Who, me?
So. You damage some people at school, man.
Wait, say I got to do me?
Listen, I sue you.
You sue me?
Yes.
Burn up, so I'm a cousin. Brr.
You lie me.
You know what? 10 o'clock. Later photos.
Cool.
Yeah.
All right, Shells.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, it's now 10 o'clock. The time is brought to you by VJ Printing Services. And do remember that Real Talk is sponsored by Bayview Eco Resort and Spa and Builders Depot Hardware. Soon forward.
Architects, draftsmen, and surveyors, get your drawings printed in high-quality professional standards. We can satisfy your printing needs. Whether it is for presentation to your clients or for submitting building and subdivision application, make it VJ Printing Services. Whether drawing by hand or with computer-aided softwares, we will plot your negatives and print the copies as you need. We do high-quality white paper printing that is water-resistant and never fades, unlike traditional blueprint. For more information, call VJ Printing at 893-2266.
Calling all bars, calling all bars.
This is an all points bulletin.
It feels so good to be back.
It does feel so good to be back. Hey, what we call it again?
Bar Roundup Volume 2.
Yep, it's the 2016-2017 edition. Bigger, better, better than before.
You know, Styles FM DJ, I got dead there for shell down the bar round up them.
And a simple maths, you provide the bar, we provide the entertainment, the advertising, and intermediate updates of the night proceedings from the venue.
For bookings, call 286-9216 or 993-33-58. You know what I mean?
You can't afford to miss this one.
Yes, I am openness.
This feeling is taking over me. I'm so excited.
Feel the euphoria.
Tuesdays from 5 to 9 p.m. with the master mixer musical maestro digital team.
Giving a total satisfaction with melodies and memories by the score. With the widest selection of genres and hits. So you don't know the program you turn up, you know. So you know Patek's a full dance, the one you slap with.
Digital and we are party. Yeah, we flawless. Euphoria the program. Every Tuesday.
5 to 9. Every Tuesday.
With the musical maestro digital team.
Are you planning on doing construction or building repairs soon? Or just simply in need of household items? Builders Depot, located at Bryan's Bay, Port Antonio, Jamaica, stocks building materials, electrical and plumbing supplies, paints, tools, plus household items to make your dream home a reality. And guess what? We have a special payment arrangement for overseas customers. Contact us at 876-715-3128 or 876-284-3337. Builders Depot. Once you need it, we have it. Builders Depot, a sponsor of Real Talk with Lady Cleo and Daddy Rude, Monday nights from 9 p.m. to 12 midnight.
Yep. So
yes, welcome back. We're all getting caught off guard here. Yes.
Too much behind the scenes.
Oh, too many behind the scenes, can I tell you? All right, we're going to rush quickly to the WhatsApp messages and get out some of those before we go right into our Vox Pop for tonight. All right. Kevin in Florida says, greetings again to me. Thank you. Daddy Rude, a good youth. You don't fight women. I like that. Yeah. Just make woman beat him up and talk about the elastic bands. Yeah. But for all he did to the women, otherwise with his pencil, he deserves the beating. Yeah. Man beater. Hey, man beater. Who him talking? Who you talking, Drake?
He's talking about Shells. Shells.
Next one. Next up, who we got there now? Let's see. What Tarry? Well, Tarry has got that one already. Charm. Hey, Charmy, Charmy, Charm with your charming self. And Charm says, okay, that makes two of us. She said, on how I kept my thing private. No, I didn't keep nothing private. I didn't have no party, baby. Nothing like that. All right. Let's see what the boy has to say. Well, the boy says, he's laughing about something. A whole heap of dead with laugh about something. I'm not sure which part of the show, but we're moving right along. All right. One of our avid listeners, and we appreciate that every time, the boy. Suzette. That looks like Mr. Richards from Anchovy Land Settlement. Yeah. Good night to you, too, Mr. Richards. You're locked in straight every time, she say. Big up, big up, big up yourself and the family. All right. Cool. All right. Who up? Who's next? Who next? Punchinella, little fella. And we go quickly to Cadian. Happy belated. Thank you, Cadian, honey. Gracie, we got Gracie already saying good night to us. Thank you, girlfriend. And that's about it. No? Oh, let's see what R&B barbershop in the UK is saying right now. And pretty much Daddy Road gave his money and lunch to the girls. I wonder what he was buying or bribing them for. Is it that thing he was looking for with the pencil? I don't know. It's a possibility. Because he's a sneaky, ladies, rude fella, you know.
And gentlemen.
All right, there we have it for the text.
My reputation is being tarnished by my co-host. So I think we should go straight into the box pop question, my engineer.
I think so too.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So tonight we're going to talk about...
Yes, Charm, I do, just like you, I'm sure. Love it, bad, bad, bad. All right? So let's see what the WhatsApp... Oh.
So the WhatsApp, the Vox Pop message for tonight goes like this.
An interesting one, can I tell you?
Ladies, would you date a man that's effeminate or metrosexual?
Massa.
But he isn't gay. State your reason. And men... Would you date a woman that acts and dresses masculine, a.k.a. a man royal? And state your reason.
Deliverance.
I have my experience with a man royal a couple weeks ago.
You did?
Yep. I was on my way to the photo shoot for the calendar. And for some reason, this bridge in a drive, a CRV, swerve out a pothole by Manchneel, so I head on to my car.
Wow.
And I don't know why I never swerve back on his side. It was heading straight. I'm going to swerve out of him. And him hit the banking and overturned.
Seriously?
Yep. So I park up now. And I'm thinking to myself, all right, what just happened? I'm saying, hold on, people are with me. I'm smiling most of that car. I'm going to the car.
You serious?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And on the back seat were two female, front seat, the driver alone. Male.
Or presumably male?
Male.
Okay.
Help him out, help them out of the car first, and then help him out of the car. And one of the female them was a man royal.
You mean turned over like reciprocated? Upside down?
Well, it didn't flip on the top. Oh. It landed on the side.
Oh my, wow, were they okay?
Yeah, but shaking. So
shaking, wow.
My girl, I tremble. I come to boom and run, going to my car, because I see her hand kind of dirty up and, you know, get some wipes from out of my car and go down. And I see how that was a sneak.
Oh, my God.
You understand? I make sure you know what it feel like.
Oh,
so
my goodness gracious. Was that the man royal?
Yeah.
Oh.
That would have
felt. Ouch.
Yeah.
How did you deal with that? Because you're so,
then a woman.
Homophobic.
Yeah, but a woman still has a girl. I tell you the truth. A damsel in distress. Yeah, man. The Caribbean side kicking. Same time. Obviously, because she has her shoulder hurt.
Oh, my.
She has a boy, my girl, right? And I wipe it down with little baby wipes and them things that makes you feel good in herself.
So, did you assist the driver?
Yeah, man. Hey, all the seatbelt around the neck I ain't like goat. I tell you something, I'm a virgin. The seatbelt can't pull. You have to ease up. Because
really?
him wait.
Yeah,
waiting. Him wait upon the seatbelt. Some of us say, no, you have to find a way to stand up. And him ease up. And then some of it put in neck from around the seatbelt. And I mean, I tell you, I had to.
That was an experience.
Yeah, but I'm on right that word, right? I don't still.
All hey, right, so.
Well, I know.
I guess she was dressed like a male.
Yeah, man. Tight pants. Right, you know the band them nowadays have them pants well tight.
I can't stand
she,
it.
You know, one kind of marina something. Yeah, and it's sleeveless.
Mm-hmm.
And then one I don't remember what kind of sneakers she have on, but just like, oh.
A stubby guy with dress? Yeah.
So me, I tell you, sister, when I come so boom and I look on the neck, I say, my girl, if you put her next, make put that icky on your neck, put her next on the next side.
Oh, yeah. My goodness. I'm sure that must have cheered her up.
No, but my feel say, I tell you the truth, my feel say has something that go on the back seat. Make my mind distracted. God, no.
Uh-oh.
Nobody can't tell me otherwise.
Oh, there were two women in the back, he said?
Yeah, man.
Oh, the man royal and another...
And a real royal.
Oh, Jesus.
And a girl royal.
Oh, Jesus. So he might have been distracted for real.
Yeah, man. I feel there's something that go on, man.
Oh, my goodness.
I feel there's something that go on. But, you know, you have quite a few of them out there where they don't look bad, you know, when you look upon them.
Some years ago, I went to 24/7 in New Kingston.
Mm.
And that was when it was hitting me that...
When you're in 24/7?
It's like a club party venue. And... I remember we were there. We were one of the first set to go. Because we left college and stuff and we were going to party that weekend. And exam finish and everything, you know? One of them things there, right? So we were there up in the place early out in the evening. And of course, people started rolling in. And can I tell you? I saw what I thought were men coming in. Walking in them, you know, men pants, looking pants and... Men looking shirt, because I'm going to say men looking shirt, because I guess some things a woman can wear it too. But based on what we learn in society, is a man's shirt. These women had on men's shirt and pants and a boot, some tough boots that really looked masculine. Lo and behold, can I tell you, the walk they had were what you would call like a thuggy, thuggy, macho looking thing. And they had on their sides... The daintiest side note girls who were in the high heels and all prim and proper dainty and cutie girly, yeah. That was how we were dressed. And these girls were walking in with them on their arms. And I really thought they were men. I learned later on that many of them who we saw there and thinking that they were men were actually women.
So, hold on there. All you're talking about because... Me kind of zone out at a certain point. Well, me thought just stop at one point when I say some of them dress like man. No, when you say dress like man, what do you mean? They mean the tight pants with certain man.
No,
wear.
Not at that time.
Mean a baggy pants.
No,
where you talk
it wasn't
about?
The tight pants, Daddy Rude. It was just a man's look. Apart from the fact that men are now taking off from the women and wearing the tight pants.
That's why more you clear up the argument.
They looked like. Men in man loose pants on their legs, sucking to the legs. No, but it had that look like a man's dressing. Yeah, that's how it looked. And the walk, you know how men don't walk like they're walking on ice. We walk like we're on ice in our aisle boots some of the times. And like we're going on the catwalk down the runway for Miss World or something. That's how we walk in our heels. Mm. Or most women walk in their heels. So I'm saying...
But let me ask you though. The woman part. Would you date a man that's effeminate and metrosexual, but he isn't gay?
I don't think I could deal with it, no.
Why not?
I believe if he's effeminate, then he's pretty much on the very emotional side, for one. And he probably would talk and gesticulate like a female, probably. And then just the attitudes that a woman or me as a woman would display, I don't think I want to have a male who should be the, well, quote-unquote, opposite of that then or, you know, far away from that. I don't want somebody like that to deal with. I'm socialized to, you know, have a male. Yes, a macho figure. A masculine, that toughness, yes. At the same time, I want him to have a balance where he can empathize and sympathize and have that side to him where he is sensitive to the needs of his woman. But I want him to be a man. And a man is not someone who is effeminate or shouldn't be so delicate and dainty. And he goes... to the bathroom and he carries a special little basket with special face products and just operating like how women operate. I can't deal with that. Leave that to me.
So about because you have some man where always have the lip gloss.
Lip who? No, if it's in the summertime and really have cracky lips and you have the lip balms, I can respect a man who will put on a lip balm. But it can't be the one with shiny like it does on each chicken back. Another one there.
Them have them chapstick.
And always applying it? Hell to the no.
Serious, something real, something I talk about.
No way.
One of my sisters tell me about a bridge and say, well, the bridge and have far one chapstick too. Like,
no.
So him have all a spear.
There are certain things that you know. Mark you, don't get me wrong, ladies. Listeners, I want a man who knows how to carry himself. I don't like tacky. I don't do tacky. I hate tacky. Yeah? But he, in the same breath, he knows how to carry himself. I would expect too that he would understand that he can't operate like a woman.
Then if a man have a lip gloss and he wants to make sure that every time he kiss it, it would I say juice.
Wait, call up. We invite you to call right back, please. 453-1444.
Yes.
My mind is not going to the place where I can figure out some things that.
Hold on, let me talk to Cass. Can you get too diplomatic again? Let me talk to Cass. Until you get diplomatic, me no want to hear what you're saying. There's a Cass like all me know where the vehicle.
I thought we have a caller online. Hello, caller. Good night.
Hello.
Hi, how are you? Welcome to the show.
You know, sex. You have woman.
Can hardly hear you, darling.
Do you know, she have woman that look like my man. A beat up man.
Yes?
Let me tell her, my daughter is a mother. Half a tree.
Yeah.
I know this guy just to the girl.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to tell this girl, give some dark eye leak. Drape him up and lick him like a man.
Mm-mm.
And when you look at the woman, you can't believe it's a woman do that.
Oh, but my.
A man. She tough.
I'm not laughing.
Not serious, you know. When we look, man, the boy from running, man, coward. He come and she come up and go and get her ear there.
Mm-hmm.
She give him some lick.
Mm-mm.
And when the police man come, police.
What? Bad girl.
Some girl love them and look like man and weak.
Yeah.
It's a technical man. If you give them up to two times.
A true.
Yeah, man.
Me say them a come and run, gun. I mean, I take no leg. Me run, take foot in a hand, run.
If you say about to the man and then girl, they see you and say, I want you.
Yeah.
Man can't defend it.
He really? So wow.
I saw them work.
Mm-hmm.
They say, I say, you don't want to hear it, and they've been charming here.
Wow. I'm wondering, though, if there are men out there who are attracted to these women, because some men end up with some of these women, and I'm wondering if they just end up with them accidentally or they really went for them.
With them woman there.
Yeah.
Them pimp,
you know? Oh.
Yeah, I saw them work.
Mm.
Yeah, I mean, they can go on and date girl, and then the man royal Ryan.
Mm-hmm.
I say work. But everyone get too far now, but I say work with them.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I mean, them bring them in, and then trying to start too far. How I see the girl just let the man and start stick around the girl.
Oh. I see.
Yeah, I saw me. I saw them a man ride and work. Them just want a man.
Yes.
In a woman. Cause they just come up here and say, yo, man, what more are you? You know, like it. Make something go on for me. I saw them work.
Wow.
All right.
So caller, tell me something. Would you date a woman like that?
No. Cause my woman look like a woman.
Okay. All right, caller. Thank you.
Yeah.
Oh boy.
Look at now. I'm gonna play on box swap in a car.
All right. Good night, Real Talk family. So Daddy Road, box pop tonight. Brr. Straight bun up. Bun up, bun up, bun up, bun up. Bun up and reburn it again.
So what may I do with a man where effeminated or is a metrosexual? We can't do nothing with that. Me not even to want them to be my girlfriends or a friend or a acquaintance, much less. So what may I do with that? No, me already have, me not even want my man for too into him feelings. Me want him able to talk and discuss my feelings with me and tell me when there's something wrong with our relationship or he's going through something. But me no want a man where I go tell me, say, oh baby, your makeup, put it on like this. Let me show you how to put it on. Or me I go put it on for you. Or me I go do your hair and them something. No, sir. Bun up daddy road. Straight bun up. Me can't even done bun up this.
Say, obviously, you know really know your industry then. Google the artist formerly known as Prince. Or Prince, the one that sings Purple Rain. Prince was a straight man and Prince wearing makeup. And you can't tell Prince same gear. Prince not upon the back door business. Prince lip on the front door business. You hear? You can't tell Prince M gay. And Prince rocking makeup every day. So I mean, I know where you talk about say you don't know no man will wear makeup. You better you say you don't know no man in your personal circle when no wear makeup. But man the other road will wear makeup and them defend the front door. You hear? You know your rank. What you mean me no on top dresser? Me no me no on top dresser, but the man nothing have on makeup and me no have on makeup. And in the business fair wear lip gloss if me now wear for my lipstick. And in here nothing perma or a jerry curl. I'm here wear my kinky. And trust me, I've dated men who are effeminate. Them go get them manicure and them pedicure on weekends and them beard will line up and them hair line up. But that no means to them feel rocking makeup and me not rocking makeup. You hear? And not true, you know, see me as non top dresser. Me got little taste.
Hell no. From day one, I wouldn't be dating him because I ain't going out in public with him because then I'm going to be labeled gay.
No. Yeah, no, no. It's a simple word. No. For what? You can imagine now. Little more, Emil Amon go kick in little more. Then, I've already learned that about your turn. No, man, I did something violent start, man. Eh-eh. No. For what? No, man, I done masculine already, man. No need to masculine. That is. No, man, fire.
Can I tell you though that Winston shared the view that he was born and raised in a society where men are attracted to physically sexy women who are curvaceous and sexy and look a certain way.
Hold on.
So why should he now adjust himself to being with a man looking all woman?
Right. You see, this is one of the things, you know, if I make up my mind. And me want to tell me if me wrong, because this a woman here enough time. Enough time. A man say, yo, that food look trangy. Talk it out. When a man say a cat look trang, she not must have that kind of, the man look there, band leg.
Hold that
band
thought.
Leg look there.
Hold that thought.
He cast it, look a band leg, hold, I walk down.
Hold that thought. Do I have bandy legs?
That
cat
look trang.
Do I have bandy legs?
What man says he look trang?
Answer the question. Do I have bandy legs?
I never really look for you. No. I'm not telling you. I never really look
Cassidy, for you. Have you ever seen me looking like I have bandy legs? I walk bandy legless.
Hold on.
But I don't have bandy legs.
No, hold on. Why you ask a question? What man tell you
because
say strong?
Because food, I've heard, boy, that food look good, you know. That food look sturdy, you know. I've heard that.
No, hold on. Me ask you a question.
No,
I'm not. Why, yo, you look strong, you
know? No, I'm never hear the exact words, dear.
Not strong, you know?
Strong? No, I'm not get the one, the man.
Yes. You never hear a man say, yo, aye, that be the look strong, you know?
No.
What do you mean by that?
I can't masculine.
Then, what then?
Sturdy, maybe.
Then, well, no. You try to find pretty word.
No, not pretty. You try to find pretty word. You try to start the pretty.
Yeah, I find pretty word.
The stir or the day.
No,
daddy. Trang. No, I've never gotten trang.
You never get
trang sound.
That means that.
Trang sound hard.
That means that you're over the feminine side. Where you fit there? Right? No, when I like catty a pass road boy. And you know, say, normally a footballer. When you grew up and, you know, you
I step strong in my shoe and I've heard one man say some years ago, boy, you walk strong in your shoes.
That's a different something.
Okay, fine. Go ahead.
Yeah, well, that woman, that strong, you know.
That sound like a one heavy, masculine-ish something.
Me, I try to figure it out because we have to make up our mind, you know. Because I remember back in the days, Cass, in the 90s, most of the hip-hop group, them TLC, them started off. And what the name? En Vogue? En Vogue the woman? Which group did the one about? I'm freaking on the day. I need a freak. Freak in the morning. And a salt and pepper. Even salt and pepper. Baggy jeans. And that used to rock then time there.
Mm-hmm.
Timbaland.
I remember. And
so what if you make up your mind? What if you make up your mind, you know, Cass? Because what difference between them woman there and the one them know where wear the tight pants? Because the gangster them wear the tight pants now, but then the gangster them wear the baggy jeans. And a whole pa woman used to rock the big shirt them, even when name the jumper them.
Mm-hmm.
So them have on the jumper and one strap down,
yeah,
and one strap over the shoulder in a them big boat.
But you have some girls who dress that way and accuse it.
Well, I know a man dressed that way there and walk with the woman and then pair up. Right? So what the difference now when a man dressed tuggy-tuggy and the woman dressed tuggy-tuggy like him? What's the difference
now? You
know,
let me tell you.
We can't be hypocrite, you know?
No, right? I think there's a difference with a woman who is looking like a woman and dressing thuggy as opposed to a woman who's looking like a man and dressing thuggy. Because the woman who looks like a man and dresses like a man or dresses thuggy then,
yo,
is going to look like a real man. You have some girls who they're in their Timberland and them baggy jeans and them jump on the hat, turn the other way, and them look darn cute and sexy. Because her physique...
Not sure what that's
because of... No, I'm telling you.
Just like
women out there dress like a male, but they look sexy with it. Tight pants same way, or even baggy pants, and them look of shoes, sneakers, and them socks, and whatever, and them cap, as I said before, and them look thuggy, but them dainty with the thuggy look.
Check back the music video from the 90s, man. I don't know.
But those girls, TLC and the one, Usher's ex-girlfriend, I've seen them. She was a part of TLC, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
And I've seen them in those videos, and they look girly and cute.
They look girly and cute for some of the time.
Yes, and
but,
I'm saying...
But the same one, then, you know, they start lift weights and get thick and tough, you know. Thick and tough and in belly flat and full of muscle.
So are you saying then that a woman who does weightlifting, you see all these muscles standing up in her body, like when... I don't even know what to say.
Like Hulk Hogan?
Yes.
Mad, but no.
When those women are out there and you see them...
Yeah.
And they do like that and they pose on their... Even if they're gonna burst because their veins, no veins, their muscles are so protruded.
Me rather work with one of the anorexic walk.
But she can lift you and carry you places and do things to you that you never imagined. You can feel things you've never imagined you could feel with her.
Yo, that sound butter. Yo, Kiasi, play next box pop. Play it now, right now, clear. God, no, you're one of wicked. Yo.
Big up on yourself, real talk, family. That dude. If a woman is black, look lesbianish. Me no want that. So it's a man where a woman I talk about with the word man at the front. Yeah, I talk about road. Nah, man, one shark shaky, man. Me no want nothing for do with that, man. I talk about road.
She had no road. The whole of my meds mash up in her sub there.
Yeah, man. I think we see myself there in that lesbian. Much less. A man royal, the butch. The one them sometime I walk and just like if you come wear my clothes them road, eh? Yeah, what? I tell a man.
Well, for me, I believe that a man should act macho any day. God made him first, and he must have made him first for a reason. Right, there's just a certain way that a man should behave. I know I couldn't really date one who is behaving like a girl. Mm-mm. Man must be man. And yeah, nothing wrong with a man who want to take care of himself, you know. But he will have a shopping and thing like a woman. No, I'm not a fan of that still. Man must be man. You can't look good, nothing wrong with that groom and all of that. But me, yeah, man. Yeah, talk about let's go shopping. Come on. That's a girl thing. Leave that to the girls. No, I couldn't date one.
Real talk, my answer is plain old flatline. No. No way, no how, no day. Now tell me something. Why must me date Marlon, but yet still Marlon act like Sharon? That no make no sense. if me need a man, me supposed to have a man, not a man one. No, sir. No way. My man should be the opposite of me. Should be masculine. Should carry himself a certain way. And so, me and my man not supposed to fight over earring, eh? Or female jewelry. No way. Or female clothes. No, sir. No, me not in it. No, me not in it. You see, the thing is, sometimes women are attracted to these people, and you wonder why. It could be that they're hiding behind the stereotype, or they may be thinking that they are actually lesbian or more attracted to women, but them use these type of men as a substitute because they're confused about them sexuality. You never know, but me definitely now go there with Marlon, and Marlon act like Sharon. You now go work now that the way. We need one man and one man only in the house, and that must be my mate, not me. All right, real talk.
Real talk, right back at you.
Javine, we soon get to that. Javine, we soon get to that. Ladies and gentlemen, it
those
is
ladies
no.
have no man royal look about them, and they are rather sexy and cute. And strong.
No, strong, my girl. No, but listen, man, look what the man write. Read what the man write.
Anyways, we're moving right along.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, it is now 10:30. The time is brought to you by VJ Printing Services. And remember, Real Talk is sponsored by Bayview Eco Resort and Spa and Builders Depot.
Stick and stay on Stars FM.
Architects, draftsmen, and surveyors, get your drawings printed in high-quality professional standards. We can satisfy your printing needs. Whether it is for presentation to your clients or for submitting building and subdivision application, make it VJ Printing Services. Whether drawing by hand or with computer-aided softwares, we will plot your negatives and print the copies as you need. We do high-quality white paper printing that is water-resistant and never fades, unlike traditional blueprint. For more information, call VJ Printing at 893-2266.
Bayview Eco Resort and Spa, boasting amenities such as restaurant, bar, spa, conference area, and swimming pool, were perfect for a business trip or vacation. Make a reservation today by calling us at 993-3118 or email us at bayviewecoresortspa@gmail.com.
Babes, where you do over there, sir? Babes, where you really do over there, sir, babes?
Me a look for the radio cause I saw schizophrenia with DJ Mookie. He have mad skills and crazy hype. And he's on this and every Tuesday and Wednesday from 1 p.m. to 5 p.m. No, me can't miss it. You mad?
Oh, hour. The hour between 3 to 4 is sponsored by Rap Auto Supplies.
Take us to work. Take us on a go. Take us wherever you go. Styles FM.
Take Styles FM with you on the go. The number for USA, 213-992-4360. That's 213-992-4360. And for the United Kingdom, 033-0010-3322. That's 033-0010-3322.
Styles FM.
Are you planning on doing construction or building repairs soon, or just simply in need of household items? Builders Depot, located at Bryan's Bay, Port Antonio, Jamaica, stocks building materials, electrical and plumbing supplies, paints, tools, plus household items to make your dream home a reality. And guess what? We have a special payment arrangement for overseas customers. Contact us at 876-715-3128 or 876-284-3337. Builders Depot. Once you need it, we have it. Builders Depot, a sponsor of Real Talk with Lady Cleo and Daddy Rude, Monday nights from 9 p.m. to 12 midnight.
No.
Welcome back to Real Talk. No. Now we have the WhatsApp page burning up, yeah? And we got to see what the people are saying. Cadian. Let's see what Cadian says. won't even try to answer the Vox Pop because Kian, whatever Daddy Road, and him burn up topic, you know. Yeah. Cadian, I hear you. Oh, I feel your pain. Strong like a stallion, not masculine. All right, that's from 11:30.
Yeah, but 916. Stallion is not a mirror. Right? So if you're strong like a stallion, that means you have man-like
features.
You see thick, clean, and fit women all around. Trunk, not strong. No, trunk not sound good. Trunk sound like chopped in and ready if it's trample you. Yeah, heavy and hardcore. But you have thick and strong, which is a different look.
All right, Shellyan, Shells.
Yes.
Yeah, so you say you don't say Shells strong?
No, I wouldn't say strong. Strong?
Yeah, man, Shells strong, man. Shells strong. Shells.
Yeah. But Shells, I know she's a firm person. Shells
kind of have Shells kind of have one little sexy to her strongness still.
Of course she has sexy.
Yeah, man, she have one sexy. Me see in our.
I've seen her in some outfits. Yeah, man. Really, exit going on. Because
I'm have to look good. One day, me see him. I see somebody walk in a white suit. I mean, I say, oh, that. When I look at me, say, Shells, me shame. I say, Jesus Christ. I say, you know what I mean?
Oh, boy.
Shells have one kind of niceness within Trang. So, me not really put him full over Trang.
Okay, then. Yeah, okay, she's strong.
No, in the summer, you know, the Trang and the feminine. You understand what I mean? I say,
No worry, you're going to be the. Bit of myself more beat next week, is it? Charm says, here in the States, they have to wear the tight clothing, I guess, because of the weather. I do understand quite clearly. But I still don't want to see a man in such tights that his member is all protruding in that tight. I work with the Asafas in their tight training and running gear. And the Usain Bolts. And Tyson look tree bad, yeah. And the Ewan Blakes, we'll work with that tight when they're running on the track. But the men who wear the tight, wear the tight underneath your pants and put on something else when the time is cold or your jeggings
when me there in England for a little time. Me that for you once when you're long, John.
Yeah, but under your pants.
And it take me a time to get used to this thing because I just feel butt up. I tell you no lie.
No, but you have to protect your thing so you don't get cold balls.
Well, I mean, I know you
have. Right, and your thing don't shrivel up or shrink away.
So every time me, I see an English bridge with that accent. I don't say long, John, remember.
Oh, Jesus. But I understand that they have to wear it for the weather. I understand that. But not too tight. Yeah, just not too tight.
King said, Missy Elliot, Alia. Yeah. But Alia.
Just the name of Alia. Missy had that thuggy look. But she was girly with it.
And even Alia dancing was more kind of
thuggy looking. Kind of dancing. Yeah, hardcore-ish. And Ciara is one of those women who redefine the mix of masculine and feminine. Trust me.
Move that there. Move the cursor. Let me see what
Ciara did that well.
Yeah, Shells look fit. Yeah, Missy gone. Missy there over the other side.
Oh, she is?
Yeah, man, over the other side.
Missy. Okay. But look at Ciara. Ciara was one of the fucking types.
Yeah, but
her
but,
dancing, really cool
no,
dance
moves.
No,
the way Ciara dance and wine, you know what I say.
Yeah,
son.
Yeah, it's what I'm saying. Her dressing was thuggy, but cute. One of those girls would wear thuggy very cutely.
And Sarah looked nice.
Janet Jackson did it too. She mixed up thug with dainty.
Sure, Janet Diana.
Of course.
Sure she did because
Janet had on her black suit, her boots, her tough boots, and her hat down in her face, like similar to her brother's looks sometimes. And she wore and she sang and she performed thuggy hardcore rock. Choreographic moves and stuff, and she looked really good as
all
a woman.
Right. But hold on, the man royal.
That's a different story.
What you say? You that talk to a man royal. You that date a man royal. All right. Then suppose she used to be a man royal, and I know she reform.
Depends on how she looks.
Because I really the hairstyle, you know, because enough of them, you know, I try them, I try hard to look like a man, you know.
Yeah, somebody don't go
no
to the way.
No, for them have to try hard. And then they realize, but no, I'm girl that man.
Well, let's see what 878 has to say. Cassidy. Mm-hmm. Up, right, that one. What's that?
Me no look feel like.
I don't get them pato here with them shorts spinning sometimes, I swear. Look here. May not feel look like a man. Fuan.
Bun up.
Bun up.
Bun up.
I guess women mustn't look like a man, and a man mustn't look like a woman. Plain and simple. Let's see. Okay, check Grace Jones. Check Grace Jones. Yeah.
Grace Jones now. How would I put Grace Jones when I think about Grace Jones? Grace Jones was a model. You see, when I'm a model, you never know whether they look good or they ugly.
So isn't it okay for a man to be a model? Because the men step out on the stage in their thuggy walk.
Very, very, very serious question you have.
Yeah, well, it's a good question because it's okay. But it's just that, are you saying then if a man steps out and walks and... He's modeling.
You know, so I'm not sure.
He's modeling. And then you have some men who will say, oh boy, well, men should model.
Sure.
But
I'm not sure. I'm not sure.
It's because, a career.
Because guess what now? Yeah, it's a career. But guess what now? You know when in a full culture, modeling started to be acceptable at a certain level. When enough we realized that Tyson, a Jamaican, the model brother there, before that, I be a born up, you know. And then all of a sudden, through Tyson, is a Jamaican, then them start look funny, and then you have Tyrese, them, and then the GQ magazine, and all. It kind of change.
Yeah.
But I don't think the model are the issue, you know, is the environment where they're in, and the kind of stigma.
Yes, exactly.
Of the environment where they're in.
That is exactly the case.
So I think that's the issue there, the stigma with the environment, because some of them can see, say, boy, I sound like a girlish boy, them, and some fierce boy then from high school, and then decide, say, boy, well, they're going to exploit their looks. But, you know, that are for them things still. All right, we have one more Vox Pop because we have one sitting phone to read. To read for you all, so we have one more Vox Pop to play.
Boy, Daddy Wood, me don't know how you just find them kind of question. Why me, as a man, would want to find a woman that behave exactly like me? That to me is a bit abnormal. Like more, when we're in bed, they're gonna want to use all kind of toys and a whole heap of nonsense. So any woman that wants to behave like Manjan, I guess in your term, it is man royal, man royal or whatever. Man, in my country, is man, and them is something and go. So that can never work, you know. That for them freaky guys, you know that.
I wouldn't want to date a man that is effeminate and metrosexual, even though I'm not gay. Reason being, if him effeminate, it means that he might go behave like him a girl, and me no want a man with a girl. Me already the girl in a relationship, and then when he metrosexual, this man, even though me I go want my man to look dapper and sharp and them things there, but this man I go take it to another level when he might go all up in a fashion and shopping and all of them stuff that I go make me look like say no sir, you not try. So I don't want him. I wouldn't even think about dating him.
Okay. Welcome back. But I would love to hear from somebody who is actually dating someone who is a male, but he is kind of on the feminine
really,
side.
Me never know say you have makeup for men.
I didn't know that either.
I never know that. As somebody overseas that say it to me.
Interesting.
And me say, boy, no, so that no exists. And me say, boy, yeah, man have their makeup kit and all them something. But you know, like the people the goth people them.
Yeah.
Them
yeah.
them put all kind
of piercings and stuff.
And I guess makeup make them skin look extra pale.
Yeah.
But that's a culture right there, so that's a different kind of movement thing right there, so.
Mm-hmm.
But
I don't, by the way, well, I call a text to say that they don't want the man to go be going shopping. Any day, I welcome him to go shopping with me, you know, and for me. Yes. I don't mind that part. And I think male hairstylists are among the best, if not the best, when it comes on to gender and their ability to do hair or to be hairstylists. I think the average man who is an hairstylist does out the average woman any day. Mark you, I said average, because there are exceptions to every rule. You have some women, hairdressers, you can't romp no man, boy, girl, nobody can test them. You have some male hairdressers who nobody at all can't test them. So there are exceptions. And but generally, men who do hair can do very, very well.
Now, Shells is saying that she's athletic.
Okay.
which that's another category now, because you have like Shelley and Fraser. You have, what is this girl from foreign name? Where? I don't remember what her name.
Mm-hmm.
The one where always around this kind of tall one, man.
No, man. I don't remember her.
Some of them look really nice and sexy.
Oh, yeah. Man. And some of them look really hard in the formal dresses when they go to award ceremony. I don't know why they must wear those dresses. Oh, don't do Semenya. Do not go to Semenya.
You want to with Semenya now. No, Semenya now, I want different situation. You can't see the physical features right there. So that's just a birthing, right? But maybe if she put long hair, it's just how she put it. Enough of the time, how them cut them hair and all them something there. Mm-hmm. You know? Now, me know straight up. Me, no matter how much money she got, that the tennis star there would just lose the number one position over there.
Mm-hmm.
Nope, no matter how much money she got, me not going there, so none at all. None at all, me not going there, so.
Okay. I don't remember her name, to be honest.
It rhymes with Katrina.
Okay.
But we have an article to read. Which one do you want to read? You have one right that's about why men would want to date a masculine type of woman. Mm-hmm. That one burn up. And there's one. You find one about money, Cass? Which one you did find a while ago?
I think that's the one I want.
What's
to
that
read.
One about? That one? Oh, yeah, this other one. Yeah, that one more you read.
Yeah.
What attracts women more than money and good looks?
I would love to. Oh, I know what attracts them more.
Let's see. Oh, before that, thank you everyone for participating in the box.
Oh yeah,
box.
And the callers, big up yourselves, all right?
All of the people them were, you know, sending them voice note and them something they respect.
And Patsy Octago says, women must look good. When a woman dressed like man, most of the time, they're on the other side. All right, and also the men who just like women upon the other side, she says. Thank you, Patsy. All right. What attracts women more than money and good looks? By Head Hudson. Let's face it, when it comes to attraction, men are simple creatures. The sight, of a pretty young woman is enough to make any man uncontrollably drool. Ah, boy. Sorry to sound blunt, but it's proven in evolution over millions of years, but perhaps not the drooling part. But what about women? Are they simply attracted by the lure of money?
Yep.
Darwin might say otherwise, and that's a philosopher. Charles Darwin, right? That's his name, right? Mm-hmm.
No.
Yeah, man, he's one of those psychologists, rather. We break down exactly what separates the men from the boys when it comes to female attraction. Let's now look at money. Money versus looks. Money. Will it solve your problem of getting the girl? Contrary to popular belief, money isn't all it's cracked up to be. Liar tell. Anyways, wealth attracts women striving to find a long-term partner, but more so as a provider rather than a lover. Money can provide stability and the ability to raise children in a comfortable environment, but when it comes to sex and reproduction, looks are far more important. There are people who don't care how ugly the man is once they get in the money. And if they have to drop a child or two in the midst, they will drop it because they was ugly. well, let me not say ugly. Those persons who are not so cute necessarily, will have a whole lot of comfort with all the money that him have. All right? Mm-hmm. All right, where am I? Women look for qualities that are reasonable, indicators of genetic health, fertility, and competitiveness, rather. As such, they imply a genetic constitution that would also be desirable in our children. That's from Robin Baker, Sperm Wars, I guess is the title of that book. So basically, a woman will go to a man or take a man based on the fact that he has, you know, competitiveness. There's good health in the genetically in terms of how he looks, the family structure, the family background, and they want somebody who has good education because they don't want the kids to come, you know. And
are we as men more look for that?
Women do that too. Women do that. Okay, so that's more about making babies. What about attraction in the dating game? How do money and looks fare here? In the dating sphere, looks only give you a foot in the door. Money, on the other hand, might be a little more useful. Amen to that. Acquiring wealth can enhance your status and move you up the marks in social perking order. Providing your wealth is not discussed, you will naturally raise your value to the opposite sex. Remember how the popular jock kids at school always always attracted the beautiful girls? Scroll. Some proof as social proof, as we will call it, is powerful component. It's a powerful component in attracting women. Right? Maybe even more so than money and looks combined. So here's a social proof, people. The social climber is a nickname we like to brand certain individuals by jokingly describe those people who strive to befriend the popular kids in the aim of improving their social status. Right? This concept can be applied to pick up as a cunning tactic to attract women and hence should not be laughed at. It's a game changer. Women respond well to status, definitely. Women do. We respond to status in the same way. You don't want us to just pick up any old kinaki because uno na just pick up any kinaki if you call
preps.
Preps, right. We too want, you know, we look for status. We don't always find it, mark you, but we look for it.
And then end up a settle for?
Quality. If you're in the company of a fun group with pretty girls and appear to be the center of attention, you will dramatically raise your value. The illusion, the art of seduction states, and I quote, the illusion that you are desired by others will make you more attractive for your victims than your beautiful face or your perfect body. I repeat that. The illusion that you are desired by others will make you more attractive to your victims than your beautiful face or your perfect body. Right? Yes. So next time you're out in the town, maybe think twice about going out with a group of guys. You will end up looking like a pack of wolves hunting prey. Oh. Any evidence you give off indicating that you're well-connected, have cool friends, and loyal followers will get girls noticing you. So you don't have to go in a clique, all the boys who are loud and rowdy and carrying on. I mean, the girls who really are attracted to that, really just now not necessarily attracted to, really, and they don't know the difference. But you stand out, or if you're even around them and you're pretty much quiet, a woman will take notice. But the one will load up and start talking, how kind of story and how kind of nonsense. She's just, God, despicable. Yeah. If you're looking to master, not so far. Being seen to be attracted by other girls is an attractive trait, and the envy of girls watching on who will be craving for a slice of the action.
Ah, you see it? Repeat that part there. So no one will see why when a man have a one catty, other catty want him. Simple. Repeat it. You repeated many things.
Being seen to be attracted by other girls is an attractive trait, and the envy of girls watching on who will be craving for a slice of the action.
And so that answers the question where women always ask, why a man have more than one woman? And a way.
Is what?
It's just the way it happens by default.
Oh, whatever.
It is your fault, right? I date Cassidy and make Cassidy look like him a hot man, so make other woman want Cassidy. And I saw this thing set.
I told Winston some time ago, look here, do not wear that pants on the road. You don't want to hear the response. Oh. You know, I'm wearing a good pants, go on the road, because I don't want other woman look for me.
Real talk.
I can't say. No, I'm not going to say, that's the reason why you shouldn't wear the pants.
So what was the reason?
I just thought the pants was
What was the reason?
I thought it was a really, really nice pants that should be worn out and not just going down the road.
What if the man want wear go down the road and make it look like going out-ish is the norm?
Take it off. Take it off. Yeah, send some. Take it off. Yes.
Competition yeah, run from?
No. I just don't think I like the look.
So what did he do?
The pretty look.
What did he do?
Dress up look.
Him more
at
no
the time,
him.
We, more weren't, no we weren't going out together.
Let me get the answers. I get the answer.
And he's hell-bent that's my reason.
So
that
you don't want any. Did he wear the pants?
Did he wear the pants? Yes, I saw him later on in the day and he had the pants. And I'm like, here really today. Good pants are quality up. And I found all the reasons in the world as to tell him why I thought he was messing up the pants. When, in fact, I don't think he was messing up the pants, to be honest. But just they look too...
They look too hype for the day.
Yeah, man.
And you don't want him to get that kind of attraction.
Who would? Let's see what the WhatsApp message. At that moment in time, I just felt like I didn't want that. But in other times, I just don't mind what he wears, really. Looking good or not, so good all the time. But yeah, I didn't mind sometimes. I don't mind sometimes in getting all dressed up.
Reputation.
All right, where am I? Reputation. Not there, no. I'm further up. If you're looking to master this part of your game, check out the Tahu of Badass or the review. So what about a man's reputation? Do the same rules of attraction apply? Surely being known to have been around the block is a massive turn off for women.
Is that true?
Some women find it interesting because they think, ooh, this guy knows his stuff. And if he's been around the block, that means he must be good. So they're attracted to that. For me, not intrigued at all, seriously. Not intrigued.
Then if you say a man have a couple of women, that means they have quite a bit of experience and can teach you and bring you to places that you have never been.
Like, seriously? Not enthused. Have a call online. Hey, caller, good night.
Yo, good night.
Hello?
Oh, good night.
Good night, you're on air. How are you? Can't hear you.
I am not that bad.
Oh, good. Good to know. So what's your take tonight?
Well, I'm just sitting and listening to you.
All righty. Good to know. Keep it locked, all right?
How are you?
I am fine.
I am glad to hear.
Okay. All right, caller. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right there. All right. Maybe that's a bit nervous. I don't know. All right. We go back to the article. And, well, in the meantime, between time, okay, we go back to the article right now. All right. So some women go for a man's reputation, right? And I'm sure that's a good trait to have. A good reputation is a good trait. This might throw you a little off course, but believe it or not, your illustrious past as a seducer is actually attractive to women. And he is speaking generally, please. Very generally, too.
Is a man writing?
Yes, Ed. I think it's Ed something.
Oh.
So some women will find a man's past, ooh, intriguing and attractive if he has been with a lot of women.
Or a certain type of a lot of women.
Yeah. Hello, caller. Good night.
Hello, good night.
Hi, how are you?
I'm not bad, you know.
Welcome to the show, sir.
Yes. Hey, let me see why a man not going to stop there, right?
Why is that?
Status.
Oh.
Yeah. Tell two lies.
Two lies,
hi,
okay.
Good night, how you doing? Like, oh, I'm good. I'm like, oh.
And that's your ride.
I started to lie right there. So all my family, you know, we secretly own Jamaica Grand.
Oh, wow, like, that we know too.
I'm like, yeah, I'm trying to keep it low. I'm just trying to keep it low. Don't talk too loud.
Yeah, because don't want to really tell people these things, right?
Yes.
And you own the latest vehicles and all these things, don't it?
No, we're not. That. What vehicle? We decided to tell her, I said, don't keep it low.
Keep it low, okay.
We have to tell too much lies, too much one time.
Oh, I see. There's written parts, in stages.
Lady Clem, you ever said we just turned 35 yesterday? Can you ever say?
Just turned 35, 25, honey. Yes, so tell me one of the lies that you've ever had to tell.
Huh?
Tell me one of those lies you've ever had to tell.
No, man, I don't have to tell a lie, man. We just go to some nice-looking girl and the other girl and just, like, we're off and we just work it.
Oh, so you're choosing nice-looking girls to go out with so the other girls like you off, right?
Not choosing them, choose because in the past, nice girl them.
Okay.
Oh, you mean?
And that works for some men. They go with some really cute girls, and other girls like to them and say, wow, I'm get she look good, she hot. No, so I make a want him. It happens.
And you're not talking in the circle.
Achoo, it happens. All right, caller, thank you so much. We're up on the 11 o'clock break. Keep it locked, all right? All right. It's now 11:02, peeps. And we go to our break.
Time is brought to you by
VJ Printing Services. And
we're sponsored by
Builders Depot.
And
oh yeah, Bayview Eco Resort and Spa. We soon come back. You're used to that part, not me. Anyways, guys, we soon come back. So stick and stay on Styles FM, all right?
Architects, draftsmen, and surveyors, get your drawings printed in high-quality professional standards. We can satisfy your printing needs. Whether it is for presentation to your clients or for submitting building and subdivision application, make it VJ Printing Services. Whether drawing by hand or with computer-aided softwares, we will plot your negatives and print the copies as you need. We do high-quality white paper printing that is water-resistant and never fades, unlike traditional blueprint. For more information, call VJ Printing at 893-2266.
Do you have or are you seeking a place to rent, seeking employment or have a job vacancy? Are you selling a car or having a garage sale? Then come see us. Let Styles do the advertising for you and you'll be on your way in no time. Contact us at 876-286-9216 or 439-5160. Advertising style. Advertise with Styles.
Be wowed on Wow Factor, Mondays and Tuesdays, 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. It's informative, educating, and entertaining.
Wow! I feel good.
Put the joy of entertainment in your ears. Be a part of the Wow Factor on Styles FM.
Are you planning on doing construction or building repairs soon, or just simply in need of household items? Builders Depot, located at Bryan's Bay, Port Antonio, Jamaica, stocks building materials, electrical and plumbing supplies, paints, tools, plus household items to make your dream home a reality. And guess what? We have a special payment arrangement for overseas customers. Contact us at 876-715-3128 or 876-284-3337. Builders Depot. Once you need it, we have it. Builders Depot, a sponsor of Real Talk with Lady Cleo and Daddy Rude, Monday nights from 9 p.m. to 12 midnight.
Welcome back to Real Talk. All right.
You're attracted to his voice?
I like the voice. Yes, it's a pretty voice.
I asked you, are you attracted to his voice?
My statement, my exact words were, I like that voice.
What do you mean by like?
I like the voice. Does not necessarily mean that I am attracted to the voice.
No, it doesn't.
An attraction to the voice would be very, could be very suggestive and have more meaning,
right,
which you're trying to pull and put on my tongue, and I will not allow you to do so.
But my question to you, you said it does not necessarily mean that, but what does it necessarily mean?
I don't know what it necessarily means in your book, but in my book, it means that the voice is a pretty sounding voice.
And that's what you like?
Yes, I like the prettiness of the voice. The
what does it
clarity
do to you?
Reminds me of my own voice.
Of your voice?
Yes. Brings me back in retrospect.
Okay, and then that being the case, and since I don't want
to... Is it Coach Mark, by the way?
No, it's not.
Okay, just checking. Because he has a pretty voice too. Leave me alone.
I just want to say that next time I hear your voice, I wish and I hope I am not thinking about his voice, since you equate your voice to his voice.
I did not necessarily equate it. It's just a similar sound. Like, equivalent sets are not necessarily equal sets. Right?
About that. I don't need much long time and mental ability and all this.
Okay. So, it's just a pretty sounding voice. Not one of those coarse boogie yaga.
That article.
Yes.
I don't like it.
Why not?
It's not true.
Really?
No.
Which part of it isn't true? Because there are some women who would like a man who has run the world. They love that.
No.
And they want him. There are some women who look for status. And they think, okay, you know what? Ooh, this guy's got it going on.
Two things women like.
What?
A man who is attractive and a man who have money. And if he have both, it even better for him.
So are you saying that there are women who will not like a man who don't have any money? That's not true.
If
that's not true,
listen, if
mm-hmm.
right, for some reason they're in the same environment and the options are limited.
Okay, do we have more vox pop?
No, let's have a debate on that.
Okay.
Am I right or am I right? Because a lot of the times people get attracted to each other because for some reason they are in the same environment, they share the same space,
mm-hmm.
For more often than not.
Okay.
People who work same place or them, well, they can work on the same building, not necessarily mm-hmm. in the same job, or them not the same job, whatever it is, and they end up to be attracted to each other.
Mm-hmm.
So in a dual circumstance, maybe money and them something might not be a factor. So just by default. But having an individual like that and that said woman may for some reason at lunchtime go for lunch and some person walk up in a nice suit and dress well, talk well, look well, that little poor smarty there get knocked.
Really?
And the only thing, if they are dating,
mm-hmm.
if they are already in a relationship that keeps them together, it's not that she don't lust, but maybe her own self wanting to be loyal,
mm-hmm.
and outside of loyalty, physically she might not gone to the next person,
mm-hmm.
but mentally she wishes a boy Janu.
But it happens.
Why me never meet that smarty there before?
It happens to men too. No,
we are done not this smarty.
No, don't justify that. You may not have a poor, ordinary, simple girl, easygoing girl, and you see this one with all kind of money. You might not run away and leave the poor girl.
No, you might not.
Operative word is might.
But the woman will.
No, that rude. You and Winston share the same view. He's of the opinion
it's a good
that
view.
He's of the view that a woman will have her man. Everything is going good, but she meets some other guy with a lot of money, and she'll just
zip
and disappear and gone because he's providing her with more financial support.
Yeah.
While a man will know that him struggle through rough thick and thin with this yeah. girl yeah. And him and her come all the way.
Same
like, be like a two room and whatever and I live happy. But guess what now? Him meet a chick now where boy can help him out a certain way of financially, set him straight. And he will just take her money, keep taking all he can take, all he can get from her because she's giving.
Because we're a scammer.
You're right about that. And he'll take all he can take and he'll bring it and even give back to this woman.
Of course.
You men are of that view, but that's not necessarily true.
It's called pimping.
It's not necessarily true. There are women, I'm sure, who will also take whatever they get and will assist their man where they can assist him.
A DBDB life that.
No, I'm not depend that.
No, a DBDB life that.
I'm not serious. No. I'm not depend on it. Seriously. It's mine, it's mine. If I'm gonna assist you, it's gonna be what I have for me, I'm gonna assist you with. I'm not gonna take.
So you're not spending next man money for
you. No, I'm not gonna take somebody's money or be all up into them and whatever and take their money and take it and go and spend on somebody else. That no.
Why not? Then we'll look at it. Yeah, tell me say you have your good man at your yard and you'll give the man some bun. You know, if you say that man if you pay him dues. If he said the bottom man for PM dues. A bottom man for PM dues.
Oh my goodness. We have a caller on 954. Hello, caller. Good night and welcome to the show.
Hello.
Hi. What's up? I'm good.
No, I don't want to pop that. I read that. Come on, take a name on it.
Only what? Okay. There are some women out there who would do it.
But Charm, what about we as men, where we take a woman money and buy things for a woman?
What's wrong with that?
Yes, sir. Maybe with a youth, we used to do it. And when we look for him, it's an idiot thing. Because I mean, no one knows who a man. And woman, take from the money, man, and next woman. I tell him, Mr. Malou, you get that, you spend that by yourself. Because you're a bigger woman than him.
Uh-huh.
You tell her, me say, listen, you're wasting your time. The guy is going to walk away because you're older than him. She never listens. She's still there. They push him out and him take him. So, he left her. He's not going to stay with her. I only went to gravitate to what she do, but I believe in it. Mm-hmm. I don't want nobody to do it to me. So they said, no.
True. Real talk. Real talk. All right, darling.
Okay.
Thank you, sweetie.
All right, putos.
So we repeat the vox pop for those who might not know what it is. Ladies, would you date a man that's effeminate and metrosexual, but he's not gay? State your reasons why. And men, would you date a woman that acts and dresses masculine or man royal? State your reasons. And most persons who have responded say, hey, as a woman, I ain't dating no man who looks and acts like a woman. And, oh boy, the men say, I am not dating any woman. Pretty much they all said the same thing. We're not dating any woman around here. We look like she a man. Talk about herself and so on. What?
You know, you can't hide and do it still, you know. You know what I mean? You know, if you really par with him. You understand? You can't hide and do it. You can't know, say, well, all right. You know, mom, it's 10 o'clock at night time. You can just link me, but no walk through your front.
But sure. But then, people, we can also, before we close out of the Vox Pop, we have a caller online. Hello, caller.
Good night, yeah.
Good night, how are you?
Cassidy, you feel me there?
Big up yourself, Cassidy, yeah.
Every day I go and take in on a show, I go and lay down, I go and listen to the show, you know.
All right, real talk.
So I call you say good night. I don't have enough credit still. I call you say good night.
Big up yourself. Enough respect.
Respect, respect.
Yeah, I'm big up the whole of the team. Yeah.
All right, darling. Thank you for calling.
All right. Bless up.
Yeah.
Cool, now.
You can know the little hardcore listeners, them still in a man, don't have much credit and just stuck up the phone and still call and say, hail up. I like it.
So, long. We start off this, you know, you attracted to the man voice.
Which man's voice?
In the builder's depot ad.
Yes, it's pretty.
So, the voice there. If a voice like that now, you there with your man and your voice like that and your man attack and your voice coming, you're going to
click towards that attraction?
No, I'm mature enough, and with age comes a lot of experience, or should. So I understand that if I hear a voice and it's pretty, I can just simply say, okay, that's a pretty voice. And it's not affective.
Let me ask a question.
Come on.
Because you do karaoke and all them something there. What if you're bossy? They at a karaoke and they talk and a lime and a drink to wine or whatever wanna drink.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And a sister go and start sing and him just zone out and you talk to him. And just zone and start look on the stage and I said, how would you deal with that?
No man, I'm good with that.
You're good with that?
Yeah, you got karaoke and me a chat and you watch the proceedings and the no, performances. Me have a problem.
No, at the time him now you and him a face to face a chat and then assistant come on and start serenade the crowd. And him just
me go tap and look to still.
No tap and look.
Yeah man, me go look to cause.
So everything good with that?
Yeah man, me good with that.
And you
my problem is we there talk face to face and we all sit on the table all night and Roseman take up and all these things and you just get up and gone. For how long gang and chat to somebody that she got to do, you must be mad.
Yo, you can't turn the talk.
You must be mad.
Yo, you can't turn the talk.
When my mom's just attack,
in the earlier stage attack, when he was to keep Sashi, Arakabesa, them turned the usher, they did it. About two big singers they did there. You know, it's a whole bunch of rap people. Missy Elliott they did there. Eve they did there.
Mm-hmm.
A Trey Songz, one of them, you were there. When them man they go up on stage, me not see moms and at all.
That's run different.
Run gone left
That's
me.
That's different. Because if I go to a stage show, I go to an event like that, and I see any of my stars that I really like, I'm sorry, you can't talk to me then. I'm so sorry.
You know, yeah?
That's the whole point of you bringing me out in the first place. Why should I be like, oh my God, I see these guys on stage and they're hot and sexy and charming. I'm going to be like, whoo, my mind going to be running wild. Right, ladies? Oh, yeah.
Why?
So if you can't handle the heat, get out of the kitchen.
Ladies and gentlemen, you know what? We just go straight
go to one ordinary local girl and chit-chat with she no, and me. When that's not going to work out.
When you run gone and them something, he give away as virgin sometimes for go and pre-mess that woman them in the club.
Lucky.
Right. So, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to go right in the letter for tonight. It's a really lovely letter. I love it so much.
Really, no.
Right? And I don't think Cleo like it any at all.
You're going to read it.
No, I can't read that.
Oh, man.
I can't read that.
Oh, man.
Remember, I'm not going to sit there, you know.
Okay, so you're gonna blow that up for me, please. Yeah, I'm told to read it. I'm gonna do whatever I want to do with it. I'm gonna blow it up.
Cassidy, you must know if you want to follow that the instruction.
Blow it up, Cassidy.
You must know, yeah, the answer.
Yes, make it large. Yes, make it large, honey. Make it large. Go large or go home.
Cassidy, I'm going to go yard now. I'm going to go yard.
I still need to be blown, sweetie. Blow now.
No, Cass.
Blow.
Change the percentage right after this.
Yes, I need to be blown. Okay, people, we're blowing it up. It ain't bigger. It hasn't gotten any bigger, Cassidy. Cleo wants big. Big words. Can't work with.
That's fine.
Ish. Medium something won't give me.
You're still not satisfied.
Medium things him won't give me. I won't like it when I'm big.
You're still unsatisfied.
Big words, man. Yes. Anyways, their real talk. I think I got myself into some unplanned trouble.
Yeah.
This is the man talking, yeah?
No, it can't be.
Oh, it's the girl talking, yeah. My girlfriend introduced me to her boyfriend, and there wasn't an issue with the friendships. Except that my boyfriend was a bit apprehensive, but he isn't so sociable. 2 weeks ago, I worked late, and when I got in my apartment, I saw a lizard on the face basin staring at me while I peed. I ran out of the house so fast and called my boyfriend to come get the lizard out of the house. He said I was being annoying and childish.
Yeah.
And he had better things to do.
I mean.
When I done with the missy, lizard made me afraid of so. I must be mad. I then called my girlfriend and she sent her boyfriend over.
Daddy Road?
Red flag. When he was leaving, he looked at me, smiled, then said,
yeah,
I didn't know you were so freaky.
Oh, I mean,
thanks for the view. I was lost for words, but only to realize that he could see under my skirt.
Yeah.
Based on how I sat, or should I say, based on him using a pencil. I don't know. But it wasn't until when I got back home, got back in the house, I noticed that my panty was still on the bathroom floor. She was so hysterical, she ran leave her bath, her panties, right?
Never have time to pull it up.
Never had time to pull it up. I was so afraid to tell my boyfriend, but he easily gets ticked off and quick to blame.
Amen.
My girlfriend called me last week saying that she didn't think I'm being straight with her and that I must come clean and let her know what I'm up to. I told her I'm not sure what she's talking about and left it at that. No, my conscience is killing me. Mm-mm. As it now seems, she thinks I'm hitting on her man. Last Friday, my boyfriend stayed over and he wanted to play secrets.
Yeah.
He revealed that he has a fantasy to do with a threesome, and said my girlfriend hinted at it.
Not a friend.
I felt so betrayed and hurt at his revelation, but I respected his openness. I in turn told him to make all kinds, let me go see if I'm getting that right. Mm-mm. I told him that her boyfriend saw my vagina.
Mm-mm.
And explained the situation to him. He got so mad.
I mean.
And called me all kinds of names.
I mean.
And accused me of deception.
Deceiving.
I've never felt so low in my life. How he hasn't spoken to me in days.
None.
I can't go to my girlfriend, neither her boyfriend, to talk to. What did I do wrong? What am I to do at this point?
Everything wrong.
Tell them what? What did she do wrong? Because from what I'm seeing, I don't know how it is that she jumped out of her underwear from a lizard.
You don't know how that happened?
I'm not sure. She saw the lizard on the face basin. Run the lizard or something. The lizard going in one corner. Because quite frankly, the lizard run from she. Yeah? If you try to, whatever. But I understand because I'm afraid of lizards. Seriously. Especially the croaking ones. But I understand that she ran out of her panties. How was she sitting so for him to see her genitals? Yeah? How was she sitting down? And nowhere in there did she recall that she had been sitting badly? Ever caller? Hello, caller. Good night.
Hello, good night.
Yes, welcome back.
I'm waiting to do nothing wrong. Empress, I hope you're listening, yeah? First thing, you're going to talk about the fact that see our girlfriend,
mm-hmm.
Now talk about the fact that her guy saw her thing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? What she talk about is the fact that she ain't told her friend boyfriend about the threesome and she now come forward with it.
Oh?
She need to brace herself because they might just go out and take it. if our friend interfere boyfriend about the threesome,
yes,
that means the guy already tell him girlfriend say him see the thing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and understand our woman frightened when it come on to the lizard thing because me have a friend that had that thing.
Mm-hmm.
And trust me, she not even know that she didn't make it when she went out the door.
Oh my God!
You get me? Yeah, because she's in the bathroom and being the lizard just come in and just take care of herself.
Mm-hmm.
I understand that. No, the sitting down, you know, yeah, but all of that can dash away. It's just that the fact that she now come forward and I say she ready for the threesome.
Do you think though that she was the one who, I mean, the girlfriend hinted at her boyfriend that okay, you wanted a threesome, but do you think her behavior in terms of how she sat or, you know, was she indicating that she wanted that as well?
Maybe because the friend boyfriend go see it and said to her, say, you know, Ray, and then would for them like a freaky self at that, but God, obviously him like a freakiness, because I'm gonna say you never know she's a freaky. Them watch too much blues or that, them watch too much white people or something. Bonfire panda. God, if my girl ever said to me, say, threesome, yes, all right, no problem. Match a threesome and then left.
Okay.
Yeah, man. Me nah said no. Why? Grandmother said, do not give up free food, especially when a big people like give it to you.
Oh, Jesus. Oh,
yes, especially when food ration.
Yeah, take it and then cut. That's a listen. And this thing with you and it's not working out. So,
Oh, Jesus. No, typical man.
After me done it.
Typical man.
Empress, I hope you all listen. No, you're not doing nothing wrong here. You just have some shady friends around you. Your boyfriend shady, your girlfriend boyfriend shady, so you need to take care of yourself.
All right, caller, thank you so much.
All right, bless you.
So, Daddy Roo, dissect it for me, please.
You know, something I don't really like talk too early, but I'm of the view that, you see, if you look from the early part with the whole girlfriend I introduce the man to you. You have to look upon that one consciously.
Mm-hmm.
Because, I mean, it all depends on the type of friendship where you and the girlfriend did have originally. Because sometimes, by the time some woman get their man and they're so glad so they finally get a man, they say, oh, you know, so we find a good boyfriend, blah, blah, blah. Oh, he's so nice and this, that. I want to meet him. You want more, you know, meet with the man. This, that, right? Mm-hmm. So, and so people become friends. And if you're, I guess, women, well, many of know, women more trustworthy with them man and them friend?
I tend to differ.
We don't know.
A lot of us are like that. We don't say a word. But then there are others who will just talk. And then probably if I were to look at the fact that men in trying to get another woman will tell more about their wives, then that's another story again, in and of itself.
What do you mean by that? Come on, hear the party. What do you say about the party? What do you say about the party? The party cannot catch me away. I know it's why I discuss about to catch me away. What do you say about a man, when man want more woman than talk about their wife? That you say?
There are some men who, when they're trying to impress another woman, or to get her, to woo her, they'll talk about something about whether the wife or the other girlfriend.
Something
usually
good.
It's not necessarily good.
Oh.
Some though.
So like they would have said, boy, I don't know.
Why am I telling the truth? I feel good when I come around in there because it just make me feel comfortable and happy, man. Because you see me, the woman, yo, the woman that kill me up here. Yo, the woman just a 9 in a star. No, I'm telling you, men do it. Men do it. Ladies, you know men do it.
No, man, don't do that. Like,
and there are some no. Hold on.
No,
man, do that. There are some no. No, it's true. Yo, I'm going, you know. I tell them, dinner, no man, I want to give me a star. I work hard every time. I'm hungry, in a star. I tell them, food, I want. Yo, baby, love me. Tell you, it's good to me, fine, because it's even love for you. You never eat dinner more night, you know. Most night when I get no dinner in my girl. Remember me tell you, man, I'm rich.
No,
you
want to do that.
Men do. Hi, caller, good night.
Yeah.
Hi, how are you, darling?
Yes, 95% of them, before them were married, take off their ring, put in at the empire.
I'm if you tell you. Then they go and can't find it.
I'm not sure what fun.
I'm not sure what fun, but then you do something there. But that's true something. If I were married, then go to them.
We can't find for me one all along now.
Beat the living hell out of him, my love. The living hell.
What's the problem, boy? What's up? I can't manage you. I can't give me dead with you.
Me, I have to find it.
Jam, I don't know no man we talk them crap that we clear talk about.
No, it's true. But it's charm. Boy, don't you have some men, charm, who will have a sweetheart outside or another side chick, yeah? And when they just meet her and stuff and things to start to even make sure I'll win him over. Or him win her over rather. And she shove him hard. No, he start to tell her all kind of negative things.
Real talk.
Yeah, it happens.
But that's about when you want, when you really want to come out of the relationship. When you can't, you know.
No. They don't want to come out. They don't want to go deeper. They want a woman sorry for them and give them nice. Give them if money. They want a woman sorry for them and give them money. Say, boy, I tell you, you know. The woman won't even help me in a start. You see, the woman at work, you know. And I'm going to pay the bills, them, you know. All kind of something. Them talk. Yeah, man. She a 9-star. I can't sleep in peace in the house there. Me tormented.
And
guess what now? He want this new girl to take him in. Sorry for him. Treat him nice. Give him sex when he want the sex. And him when him no want go home, you know. And tell life and work. Say, I work a mobby. I'm a work a Trelawney. And he want to sleep a fair yard. He might go and tell her, say, yo. So for night, I go with my girl, may I tell you, you know. One, because something I'm coming a little bit late, you know. I'm going to come from work, you know, charm. And you know what the woman do? So I go in the kitchen. All in the kitchen, I pat, turn down, wash and clean up. I'm going to leave no food for my star. So I'm eating big dinner, you know, charm. Yeah, it happens.
Hey, you're talking, I remember my bridge, you know. I'm telling about him after the break. Charm. So link back here.
All right.
And the person, what did I call it? 954. After the break, you're free
Please
to call. All right.
So, all right.
The time is now 11:31. We're going to a break. The time is brought to you by VJ Printing Services. And remember, Real Talk is sponsored by Bayview Eco Resort and Spa
and Builders Depot.
Architects, draftsmen, and surveyors, get your drawings printed in high-quality professional standards. We can satisfy your printing needs. Whether it is for a presentation to your clients or for submitting building and subdivision application, make it VJ Printing Services. Whether drawing by hand or with computer-aided softwares, we will plot your negatives and print the copies as you need. We do high-quality white paper printing that is water-resistant and never fades, unlike traditional blueprint. For more information, call VJ Printing at 893-2266.
Bayview Eco Resort and Spa. Boasting amenities such as restaurant, bar, spa, conference area, and swimming pool, we're perfect for a business trip or vacation. Make a reservation today by calling us at 993-3118 or email us at bayviewecoresortspa@gmail.com.
Portlanders, Portlanders, Acan Auto Technology, located at 33 Bombra Crescent, Port Antonio. Visit us for all your auto repair and servicing. We offer computerized wheel alignment, computerized wheel balancing, suspension checks, AC repair, inspection, and all your auto repair needs. For a complete auto repair and service, visit or call Acan Auto Technology today at 715-5205. And remember, we are located at 33 Bombra Crescent.
Are you planning on doing construction or building repairs soon, or just simply in need of household items? Builders Depot, located at Bryan's Bay, Port Antonio, Jamaica, stocks building materials, electrical and plumbing supplies, paints, tools, plus household items to make your dream home a reality. And guess what? We have a special payment arrangement for overseas customers. Contact us at 876-715-3128 or 876-284-3337. Builders Depot. Once you need it, we have it. Builders Depot, a sponsor of Real Talk with Lady Cleo and Daddy Rude, Monday nights from 9 p.m. to 12 midnight.
Do you have or are you seeking a place to rent, seeking employment, or have a job vacancy? Are you selling a car or having a garage sale? Then come see us. Let Styles do the advertising for you and you'll be on your way in no time. Contact us at 876-286-9216 or 439-5160. Advertising Style. Advertise with Styles.
Yep.
Welcome back to the final half hour of Real Talk.
The person that was calling on the 954, you can Now call us.
And
back.
Of course, the phone lines are still open. 453-1444 is the local number.
We kind of share some amount of what you say regarding the young missy. Because, all right, one person said via WhatsApp a while ago, said, boy, think the girl's stupid because she doesn't say, oh, she had to do that thing and take off her underwear. I don't really know how to do anything. If you don't hook it, I don't take it down.
Hook it where there? Is there a hook under there?
Just.
Well, there's a hook bit, but.
I know everybody have that. So nobody go down there, sir. I know everyone of us have that.
As if you've sampled everybody? Do you know that?
I'm going to send one video. I'm going to send one video.
All right. So, yes, you share the same view. Go ahead.
Right. Because how do I put it? When you talk about her sitting down, mm-hmm. maybe she the home comfortable, might not use having somebody around. And I guess, and it's a fair thing that when she go home, she does. You have some people when they go in, they don't start strip.
I don't like that thing. I do it all the time.
Just strip.
I'll be in top part clothes, bottom part no clothes really. But when I'm, especially when I'm alone.
When they're home.
All yes. Right. Hi caller. Hello caller, you're on air. Good night.
I'm sure. I'm gonna talk of the thing. That is going like in the more going with the man them the man them trick up the woman. Yes, after ring, yeah.
Real talk.
I don't know about that for true terror.
And some of them. Yes?
I'm going to bitch about the woman.
Yes?
Just to get through the front door.
True. Some of them even omit some stories. They are married with three kids, and trust me, they have one girlfriend and they're not on a picnic. Some of them lie till they look bad.
But that's not relevant.
It isn't, but those monsters do it.
But it's not relevant.
So why they do it?
Look here, hold on.
Why they do it? It's must be for a motive.
Hold on. Carla.
Yeah.
If a man have three picnic, you feel that it is relevant upon the first link. If I tell you that.
That is not relevant?
That's not relevant.
Yes, man.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, man.
Worse if I ask you.
Emergency, I have to jump up and run. Me want no one make you have to jump up and run.
Oh, look here, no man. Worse if I even ask you.
Does that mean what? So you have the three picnic?
No. Look here. Hold on. You know what people do interview and their resume left off certain vital information?
That's besides the point.
It's just not relevant for the particular job.
Oh.
So what may I tell you that for? Go give out information. I mean, I must get the work here and my business going on the road. May I fool?
Oh, my goodness. That's a point I'm making. You may lie to get some women in there in your covers.
It's not about lying. It's not lying. It's just not necessary. Me not know nothing about you yet. Why am I going to tell you all of them information there?
Oh, really?
Me not know nothing about you.
If you can tell her where you live so that one day she can come there
and you can
tell her your phone number and all these things.
We can.
Why can't you tell her that?
Look here. No man not tell woman exactly them address pan first link. Right? No man not do that. Me live a bum broke.
Hey. Hey, Daddy Rose.
Yeah.
You know, I choose that at the moment. You're not give up your personal information the panic first day. Because me run into one the other day, and that fool that I take home address and all them something there. And me have to just give up a different address. So me kind of understand you on the address part. Yeah. The three pitney part there, yes, me want to know if you have three pitney a road.
Of course.
As you said, if you have the emergency while we're together, I have to jump up our. Me want to know which one of the three pitney you are on go to.
Yeah.
No, but let me ask a question. All right, the man have three pitney, right?
Yeah.
Then you know what will be the next question? If I with one woman. Too much information. Yes. It's what I talk about, rude boys. Yes. That's not relevant.
Everything is relevant. When you're gonna
relevant.
When you're starting a relationship, it needs to be relevant.
No, but hold on.
And if there's no need to start one, let it be.
But me not look nobody for mind me picking them. Oh,
that's
relevant.
Besides the point. You're gonna end up hurting her feeling because she won't know the truth and the whole truth until something breaks out and she discovers that, oh, Annie, come for sat her out.
No, all you need to know, you see, if we're in a long-term relationship and we end up dead in a demise, when everybody come a funeral, all information will be revealed.
Argument done.
That's kind of too late. Too little be that cry.
Where, sir?
That time that's too late. Too late will be that cry.
Then that nobody can cuss me. Me no care.
All right, Jam.
That's not charm. That's terror.
Terror. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
All right,
all right, Terror.
Later.
All right, sweetie. No, you have some other men who will tell the truth.
And it don't work out for them.
And it works too. Because there are some women who say, boy, he's so honest and nice, sweet to me. He must be caring about me to tell me the truth.
Let me
give him a chance. Let me give him a blight. And then there are others who tell some other lies are fabricated. And they are lies, but them look pretty. Like if, one what him and her have and achieve. And she know, depending on how him feel her, that's the kind of person she is. She will know, he will know how gullible she is to the stories.
When,
and how much she wants to also know what experience, what wife I had experience.
When 12 o'clock come, me tell her so nice sitting with me, though. Just for making her feel good.
Daddy rude.
I mean, if I have no good meaning behind it.
Daddy rude.
Good night, Carla.
Daddy rude.
Yeah.
Me tell you something. This is one man. Because if a man lie to me and me find out, me no want him again. Tell me the truth and make me hurt right there and then. And I will live with that. But if you lie to me, me no want you. I eat that.
Why, Chan, I don't know how to work on it, but you don't get a couple lie well if I didn't make a couple lie well.
Anytime I find out the truth, me no want him. Me no want you. Me no want, no, listen. If me do something, and my man find out if my house is me doing it, I never tell the truth. Me a big fan for me, I tell me, say, listen, me do it, I'm sorry, but I do that. Yes, I'm me son. So me go lie to me, because I lie to me, me no win.
My child, me have a gamble, you know. Judgment day, you will find out everything.
Me now wait for judgment day. Me diplomatic more than judgment day, you find out everything. Remember that? Oh. You see one may find out from you don't even know me find out. And me just put everything together. I'm going to keep together. Me say, guess what? I'm done.
Wow.
Just like that.
Just like that, isn't you?
Yes.
So, Charm.
Can't tell me no lies.
Hey, that girl, I know. What you think? You think she do nothing wrong?
Yes. She's stupid. She's silly.
With what? Because one person says she shouldn't talk, none at all. Me get one WhatsApp and say she shouldn't talk, none at all, when the man bought him a play secrets.
No, something you want to find out.
Good, but what I'm saying, she's silly.
What you mean?
You know what I mean?
She run out left her panty?
Yes.
We don't even agree with the charm. Why?
She run
out left for something.
Yes.
Why is it off in the first place? As somebody here asks. Yakisha, Texas. Who goes to pee and take off their panties?
Then what wanna do? Seriously. That's why I'm asking if you're not okay.
Pull it down. Oh Jesus, for you. Oh Jesus.
Somebody not coffee where you don't go pee.
Oak.
Just pull it down. Right.
But Charm, like what Cleo said. More time when you go home, you just want to get out the heavy clothes and whatever. One of the first things women do when they go home, I pull a brassiere. Get rid of that. Boop. Maybe fear culture, well, not fear culture, fear style is just for us. When she want to go urinate, she just take off everything.
Are you serious?
No.
Fear way that.
Oh, boy. Okay, maybe,
all right,
maybe she's going to have a bath.
All right, hold on. Are we saying then, are thinking that in reality, true, the man will come over, she go take after something of his spite then, she never really run out left it?
Well, to me, she run out left it. And do it, me not think, maybe if she has spite, but she wasn't silly doing that, trust me.
All right. So pretty much then, she want maybe one of them person will sit down bad then.
Oh, really? How convenient. How convenient.
Sit down, bad.
please.
So what was her, yeah, all right. Are we saying that why she had an intention?
It's suggesting. That's been suggested.
She has something up her sleeve. She has an intention.
And then it backfire upon her then.
You know, exactly. You know how much money you don't say you don't have any. And you go sit down bad. A purpose, she purpose do.
So.
How much you sit down bad?
So here we go on. Okay, may I try to dissect it, you know? With our man now, our miserable man. Look like she never knows our man a freak.
Then she wouldn't know that. She never know that.
Well, may I ask a question? Suppose that something the man try to find out and not no go so. Cause which man? No man in their right mind. No man in their right mind now confess certain things and can talk about say, well, you know, say a friend in say she wanna do something with me. No man now do that.
Oh, men they would do it.
No, sir.
One in every 1,000. Or 1 in every 10,000 will do it.
Is a man not so special? He not fall in that category there. Me feel say a canny man can are good canto.
He man no canal. Man can it would.
Why me no know? Some can in it.
No. On whose part?
The man, me not feel, all right. No man now go just wake up and say, moms, let's play a secret. And then him go talk first. No man now talk first.
Listen. Him man now, of course, man, they will talk first, yeah. They will, but guess what?
I'm a real man, that. In a real life.
I'm a real man, that. It's hard.
But in a real life.
Listen, I have some woman will melt some man, and it's so very hard for them to lie.
Me no know. Me no, me no know. Me never so fortunate. I so salt.
You never so fortunate.
Are so salt.
I'm not so salt. Oh. Well, maybe I wanna be die out and dry out. Why lie?
Alright, ciao.
All right.
Yeah.
Let's see what the text messages are saying. Yakisha in Texas, she says, well, she has several issues with the litter. One, who takes their panties off to pee?
That's she.
One. Two, what kind of best friend she have, or boyfriend she have, that another man a killer lizard for her and not hers, or he's not there. Yeah, because she too busy and blah, 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 blah.
No, she him too busy.
Him too busy, rather. She had every opportunity to stop the examinator in his tracks.
Exterminator.
Lord Jesus. Exterminator.
Say body eyes so good.
In his tracks. And four, she need for pre our friend and our man. How convenient are the three...
That message, Yakisha, if you say a condom and a condom.
How convenient that the three 954, good night. Pop up.
Yeah, rude.
Yo.
And come run a lizard. And she and him see her and notice her, you know, she vulnerable and make a move.
She flash him.
The man, the man.
All right. Well, Anna, the man don't make a move.
Yeah.
All right. You go there, sir, before me go there. But go and talk. Because me a pre some generalship in another thing, you know. And then upon fear part, you know. Hey, well, a play, she get played, you know.
Yeah, well, I'm different to you, you know. Where you are, think?
All right, you see, all we are going, you see, the best friend go to her and say, boy, my girl, tell me what go on in your closet.
Mm.
Me no feel, say, the best friend man tell her what go on. Me no feel, say, the lizard man tell her what happened.
Me not feel no, so either, you know,
no woman.
Look on this now. Me not know why the woman would have sent fear man over to our friend house. Go, where is that? That sounds strange.
Well, the only thing about it, why me buy the argument there? You see, because she said in the early part, them have a good relationship, Agwan. Right? So if people have a phobia, and our man say, boy, yo, my girl, you're 9 years, so I can't deal with you. I have better things for doing, you know. See? And she said, where our man? We don't even know say, if when she said, where our man? She make a link with fear, man.
Mm. You see me?
Oh.
And
okay.
I'm a fear, fear man at the con artist. Because if this man I say that the friend I int him say she would have do a threesome. About the same time the friend couple years before that I said, my girl, tell me what go on, tell me what go on, you not come straight with me. Maybe the man himself I play the two friends and say, you know, say, my girl, you know, say, give one, you know, say clear. Like she said, boy, should I run a little tree some for me, but she don't feel comfortable. And I only told you and I move, me feel say you're the person. So the friend kind of probably all shocked to, you know. Anything, that's what my twist up on wicked way. So when the friend ask her, what go on, come straight with me. And I must the man tell her nothing, because any woman send them man go up on her ends and get a report, say boy, and next woman worse than friend go flash them and show them things. A war in a camp.
Yeah, it could also peaceful. So well, I want to, you know, if it's really a threesome, then one or a foursome.
me not feel say the lizard man know nothing about this war go on, man. Me just not feel say the lizard man know nothing. Me not feel say the boyfriend know the boyfriend know nothing. But fear man, him just a find out, but he lick him wicked. Because him there a look our friend neatly. And when he hears a boy, a little man see him pudding. A problem pon him. Problem. Him darkness get up wicked.
It's darkness. Okay.
Right? So me just feel say, the uncle innocent, she's a victim for one. Because, well, then again, her action kind of suspicious. Because I say, Yakisha, I say, boy, she don't know who do that. One next, Katie, I say, boy, she don't know which woman do that. Claire, I say, boy, she don't know which woman do that. So me don't know, really. Oh, then, because I say, boy, if I hook the thing, everybody will laugh off of me. Because me don't say nothing wrong if she decides that she's going to take down her thing and do her thing.
Mm-hmm. Nah, right? No, wrong with that. People go to them house and them just... them cloak up like that whole day. Them want some freedom now.
Some freedom. So maybe she start her thing, end up in the bathroom, see the lizard, run out. Me don't know in kind of probably sit down bad for true. And maybe I want to trunk food them in the road, boy. Maybe she want to trunk one them, you know, so the foot can't lock up.
Legs can't close.
Can't lock up.
No, but if I'm in the sheet now and our friend boyfriend slap to me, boy, I've never known see a freak. What I said to her, boy, if you come test me.
A dangerous road she go, because you see, like where.
Okay, but forget about our worries about the tree tomorrow or whatever. I'm another come over next week.
Well. That she probably can't think about that now. But she don't look like she have that kind of art there to me. Me no feel say she have the art. Me feel say she just get one saltness reach him. Because him conscience are killing me now. If him conscience...
Oh, which one?
The girl, remember she said, boy, when our friend come to her now and ask her, I said, come out of the closet and tell me what I go on. And she said, boy, she don't know nothing about it.
You mean our friend boyfriend conscience are killing?
Eh?
You mean you thought about her girlfriend, boyfriend, about come get twice that? Don't
hear that? No, because remember, you know, when the man left, you know, the man said, boy, Jano, my girl, thanks for the view. So the man left with the impression and said, she is showing for spite.
Mm-hmm. That's what he thinks, yes.
Right? So she has said, boy, to all fear man dark. She can't even go say nothing to her man, because right away he's going to accuse her, which in the end he did.
But then wouldn't she have been shocked too when the girl said, what you dip on?
Yeah.
So she didn't deliberately
right.
Show
so,
him.
So in a fear, Ed, now when the girl has said, talk to me, what's up? In a fear mind, she has said, the girl man go tell her, say, boy, you know, say, Ray, flash me one night.
Yep.
But as you say, it go off too easy. Me not think is well again is unless this girl yeah kind of at testy waters.
Yeah, my advice to her now is, because me feel so shocked. So my advice to her is, let the man know so she have another lizard come up next week, and then prepare herself.
But obviously she probably, boy, she just one of the innocent. Boy, me no knows. Hey, you see the friend thing, you know, good. The friend, hey, me car.
Women are, just like Thomas, you know, women are accused, man, about lie, you know. Hey, women are the biggest liars, you know.
That's not the point. We're not debating who is the biggest liar. We're saying that the men tell the lies. It's not about who is a bigger liar now, Dan. It's the reality that men will lie to women to get into their clothes and to get where they want to get with them. And if it means telling a lie so they have picnic when they don't.
That's what women do. That's what women lie so that they can get attraction from men. Women
oh, please. Who is under the scrutiny right now? Who is under that microscope right now? You men. So stay under women, there and stop attacking us.
False eyelashes, false breasts, false that. You don't know the real them.
Look here. There are men out there who know that these women have false whatever. Mark you, I don't have any, thank God. There are men out there who can tell that a woman have false breasts, and there are men out there who don't care one's rat, you know what. They want them same
and
way.
And some can't tell. Some of them can't tell.
Men don't want to can't tell.
Men are idiots. Well, then again, that's a rhetorical question for some men. You have men.
But you can't tell the same thing. A woman are idiots. When men tell them, I don't know what I lie.
Dan, please. There's a difference. When a man comes to a woman and tell her certain things, yeah? You're hearing this man pouring out his heart and soul to a woman, telling her things about his life and where he's at in his life and how he's miserable and how he's this and him that. She does not know anybody or even know his immediate situation. And know, say, him that yard where he's comfortable, I get good treatment, but him just striking bad and just one girl will go carry on. And she will not know that, and Dan. So you can't say, okay, the women are idiots because the men tell them lying, they don't believe. Some of the men are so convincing with their stories that over time the women buy the stories, believe in them, and say, okay, you know what? She got put out some more towards this fellow because she feel in pain. Yeah, the struggle is so real that she going put her heart out there and give to him. Lo and behold, you know, later on, she end up with a 2-3 picnic, yeah? And discover afterwards that this man have him wife and him family elsewhere. Sometimes it happens that way.
But
so he has two lives living.
But Dan.
Women, they lure men in the whip, and when they fight into the whip, you know, there is. Well, this is not so. They're not here.
That means you're una idiot. That means you're una the idiot, then, man.
No, I know I've had now. I have 7 kids already, you know. I managed to get you in. It's after that. I've had to get him knows I have 7 kids, you know. I know cases like that.
I am not saying that there aren't cases like that. I'm just trying to say to you that who we're looking at now under the microscope are the men and the fat. Men will lie to get what they want just as much as there are women who will tell lies too. But when you compare the women's lies to the men's lies, believe me, uno classic.
Clear. Dan. You mean unfair, no, real unfair.
I'm not being unfair.
Dan, that lie debate now got tough, you know, because I say clear next thing, get up, wicked, yeah. So,
so hey, you know what?
So you touch a button, but we almost have to wrap up, Dan, so we're running here.
Yeah.
Respect.
How
I'm looking at this thing, I think she's a victim of our friends. And what I think though, this points out that say, you see, them have a saying where them say, boy, every man would sex another man's girl. Now, when this Bridgina realizes that when he realizes a woman have a secret, and I say, she has a boy, she has fantasized over this other man. She has said, yo, look, you know, so what do you when you never turn up to help me catch a lizard, and next man turn up to do that? And this occurred in error.
She did that, right? And he didn't believe her. He carried on.
Right. So may I say, I think that's the thing with him now, you know. Him knows him out there probably I put argument or I make it look like. Probably even I use fair name to the friend. Mm-hmm. And I say, you know, say, so and so, I wonder if you would have do this. And then you know, at the same time, he might play him own a girlfriend. I say, you know, say, me have a fantasy, so, but so and so say she kind of a hint at that. What she usually do is ask him, since you are so antisocial, how you reach a point if you have that kind of conversation with my bestie? Right?
Interesting question.
That is that a way she need to go with it, you know, because see the man begs now and accuse you of something when him apparently didn't even want to go behind everybody's whole agenda. Well, everybody's own mindset to satisfy theme agenda of his him fantasy. Because he knows everybody a friend, but him still want to do that the man the girl. Him not the man, you know. Have nothing to do with the man. They never like the friendship.
The men don't normally
like
do.
Right?
They avoid the men.
But yet still, him want to have sex with the man girl. And probably other guys, threesome. But then when him hears the man say, him girl pudding, him can't deal with it. But us, made us feel, say, you have to make up your mind, say, but me not think say, the environment where you're in are the right one. And me feel say, your man are the problem. And you are being played by him. Your friend would have rung up if she actually, and this is my view, you know, my girl, because and I must say, if she's actually entertaining them kind of thoughts with your man, she made an effort to come to you to find out what really are going on. Because maybe she never did believe him in the first place. But you never open up to her and say, boy, this is the situation. But, well, it probably was a cautious move on your part because you thought that is her man got to say, boy, you flash him. Boy, you think kind of one way. I don't know where you want. If you want to keep the friendship, you have to just say, boy, it's a misunderstanding and this is what occurred and me apologize. Even if you're never wrong, because some people don't apologize if they're not wrong about something, but sometimes it's probably the most diplomatic thing to do.
It is.
What you say, Cleo?
It is.
Ask what you say about this, yeah?
I'm listening to you.
My girl, I don't know what you do because friendship is one thing, but I'm not too like the fact that your man is this up certain way. I think your man should really bring certain things about your friend. If you want to do a threesome, I don't even know, yeah, sir. If I know your thing, I know your thing, yeah, sir.
I just think she needs to just avoid them both.
Or all three of them?
Yeah.
So a relationship with our man mash up and our relationship with our friend mash up.
No, just avoid the friends.
The friends, but what about our boyfriend where apparently want to in a something with our friend?
And forget. Fire.
No, that message such end up without friends and man.
Well, choose again, honey. Life goes on.
You want to put us straight up. That road good for running lizard. So you know the thing set already. 4395160. Everything jiggy. Ladies and germs.
I've never heard this before. Girls out there who have lizards in their home, you got the number. Hello. Wow.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have come to the end of another wonderful show. Thank you for your participation. Big up Charm. Big up Dan. Big up everybody we call. Big up Tero.
Shelly, Tario,
right. Big
Tero.
Up Shells. All right, and everybody, Kieran,
Drake,
and all
everybody.
Of the crew. You know what I mean? Big up Colors, massive East Portland. And remember, on the 26th of November, our first bar runner for the 2016-2017 is going to be at Under the Rock. And it's titled, Black and Delete, Cassidy? Black and Delete. So, you know, say,
okay.
DJ Flair is going to be there.
Mm-hmm.
And Digital T is going to be there.
Oh, yeah.
You know, and trust
good lineup.
It's going to be a crazy, crazy. And you know, Digital T, Sheldon.
Man, I know. I know both of them shell.
Man, and we get a good review last week, though, from the guys on my U-Tech. About them love our DJ Mookie and Digital T.
Oh, yeah.
You know, have the crowd and things. So expect Black and Delete November 26th to be an excellent start to the bar roundup series. So you do your part now.
Yeah. All right, guys, and until next week, this is Lady Cleo on behalf of Cassidy and my co-host Daddy Rude saying, hey, until we meet again, be good, be nice, be good to yourself, and then of course you can learn to be good to other people. Love yourself and then you can love other people. All righty, until next week, guys, Lady Cleo and the others saying Ciao. And thanks for the greetings, guys. Thanks, y'all, for all the wonderful things you said and the greetings for the birthdays. Keep it locked to Stars FM because, trust me, it doesn't get any better than this.
Can't answer my part, no?
And Daddy Rude would always tell you,
big up my wife for life.
Bye, guys. Until next week.
This is Styles, 96.1, the People's Station.